So it's live now?
Yeah, let's go.
Is that right? Let's go. I'm going to
feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost.
plans. Wish that I could stay forever this young, not afraid to close my eyes. Life's a game made for everyone, and love is the prize. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself, and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up. Ladies and gentlemen, Football Federation Victoria welcomes you to Amy Park for today's Victorian Premier League Grand Final between Bentley Greens and Northcote City. A reminder that spectators must adhere to the FFA Spectators Code of Conduct. Spectators attending a match must never use violence in any form towards another person. Comply with all terms of admission, including provisions relating to security screening, intoxication and items that are prohibited by law and restricted by policy from being brought into the venue. Never throw missiles, projectiles or objects of any description at any person. Do not enter or attempt to enter the field of play or playing arena without lawful authority. Refrain from any disorderly conduct or conduct that may injure the reputation and goodwill of the code of football generally. Any person who does not comply with this spectator code of behaviour or who otherwise causes a disturbance will be escorted out of the venue.
Shining up. we got that fire, fire, fire. Yeah, we got that fire, fire, fire. And we're gonna let it burn, 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 burn.
Jesse J, Shadown. Oh.
If I go hard, let me tell you that it's worth it. Play the right cards, I ain't afraid to work it. Brush them right off when they say I don't deserve it. Hang on to my heart, you keep my fire burning. Hey. Oh, it feels so crazy when you scream my name. Love it when you rock me over every day.
to ash and dust. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up, then checking out on the prison bus. This is it, the apocalypse. Whoa, I'm waking up. I feel it in my bones, enough to make my system flow. Welcome to the new age, to the new age. Welcome to the new age, to the new age.
And a very good afternoon and welcome to Amy Park in Melbourne. It is a delightful day for the celebration of the 2013 Victorian Premier League season. Greg Blake, Doug Hodgson and Griffin McMaster on deck to call all the action as the Bentley Greens go head to head with Northcote City for the biggest prize in Victorian soccer. It is a glorious day, Dougie. I don't know about you, but I highly anticipate something special this afternoon.
Well, Blakey, I think today, mate, a little sunshine and 27 degrees. You know, a bit of a tea. We'll probably step in there later on, mate, into the game. But these both sides, I suppose, mate, have not won this competition finals before. So one of these boys, as you said before, mate, are going to go home winners. And unfortunately, there's only one winner today.
So a big grand final to look forward to. The team warm-ups have been completed and you do sense, don't you, when you're watching the teams warm up that they will be incredibly nervous. It's a big stage. It's a wonderful, wonderful stadium. The surface looks fantastic. Are you thinking, Dougie, have you had a thought about which way the game's going to go this afternoon? The thing that I like, that I particularly find engaging about this particular encounter is the fact that you've got two coaches in John Anastasiadis and Goran Lozanovski, who as players were attacking and wonderful to watch, and I hope that translates into the two sides' performance this afternoon.
Be interesting to see, Greg, because I think you know, Johnny A, you know, he loved playing forward and he was going forward all the time, and Goran was as well, so it'd be interesting they take this concept into the coaching. You know, obviously, they're going to be very scary and nervous at the first point of kickoff, mate, but is the team going to grab it by its horns and really go and have a go at each other, or are they going to step off? You know, it'll be interesting to see how the teams fall out there today. Will it be 4-3-3 or, you know, 4-4-2 or 3-5-2? Will they go the Dutch system that everyone's playing, or, you know, will they go and have a go at each other, which will be an absolute great game? You know, let's be fair, Northcote banged in 5 goals last week against South Melbourne, so we know they're capable of scoring goals, mate, but can they do it on the big stage? You're going to be feeling a little bit nervous down there. You know, the players will be getting ready for the team talks and doing the last bits and pieces, but we'll go into that a bit later on.
Yeah, plenty to talk about as we go forward. The teams that are coming through, we'll go through those in a moment. The stadium is alive. It's pounding with electricity. Well, it's, you know, it's not pounding with electricity, of course. That would be an OH&S issue. But it is a fairly exciting sort of day. Great anticipation for two clubs, and without, I shouldn't be treating it lightly. It's great anticipation. Two clubs that have never won it before. Unfortunately, today at the end of 90 minutes, or whether it's extra time, but at the end of today, one team walks out of here champions and one team just walks
Ladies
out.
And
so there's a lot on the line as we go to you, Griffin McMaster, young Griffo, for the first time. Griffo, you've cast your eye across the two teams. You have an intimate knowledge of these two sides. Which way is it going to go today?
Yeah, thanks very much for joining us, Greg and Doug. It's great to be here in the box, and it's a beautiful day weather-wise. Just to let you know, guys, that both clubs got promoted in the 2010 season. So both clubs have come from the state one from 09, and here they are, they square off today in the 2013 grand final. I'm going to say it's a very tight one, but I'm going to lean towards Northcote in a very, very tight one. Or restricted
by policy. I think Griff, I think you know, the they won the pre, as you could call it. They won the league, as I, you know, the old days. I think Loz has had a great season. He's got some young good kids there as well. Some older heads. I think I'm just looking through the team sheet now. I've been lucky enough to be involved with some of the players coaching in my due time. You know, there's Wilford at Bentley, James Cut at the Cedars at Northcote, obviously Adam at Richmond when I was coaching. But mate, I'm hating this. Little bit of pace looking at the front line up Northcote. I reckon they've probably done a fair bit of damage this week, this year, Griff.
Yeah, well, they have been full of goals all year. They've finished, I think, with 44 points in the regular season. I think they got 31 points in the first 11 games, and they were setting an absolute tearaway lead. I think it was one of the best starts they've had in a VPL. And the second half, they only got 16 points, so they finished, I think, 47. But they had a bit of a lull in their form, but they still managed to win the title, and they were far too good. In the first semi, they were just slightly out-muscled an extra time through a double Ryan DeVries, but last week they were absolutely clinical in a 5-0 win. And as I said, they have got a very good attacking lineup through Kalafatidis and Lewich and Piemonte, and I'm sure we're going to see more of them today.
Griff, what can the viewers expect today, mate? What sort of lineup do you think? We'll start off with Bentley before we go over to Northcote. Obviously, Northcote being the minor premiers, but Bentley, how have they played this year, mate? And what sort of lineup has Johnny A done with the boys this year? And what do you expect out there today, mate?
Johnny A, he plays a very, very good style of football. He loves to play the ball on the ground, not a lot of long balls, not a lot of balls over waist height. So I think we're going to see a very short, sharp passing game, a little bit of tippy-taka. Look, they have been the second best team in the competition on the minor season, and they've had a very good season. They progressed from last year. Luke Sherborne's been one of their danger players, who's been, you know, fantastic. He's been on the big wage, but he has responded that, and they've been very sound. I think their goalkeeper, Stuart Webster, came mid-season. I think this is his fourth club, so you know he's in the Tiger Woods category. But the music starts to play over. Well, back to you, Greg.
So we've got some highlights coming up. Watch and enjoy.
Sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no, I get a good feeling, yeah. Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. Godzip.com. Now I got a word for your tongue. How many Rolling Stones you want? Yeah, I got a brand new spirit speaking and it's done. Woke up on the side of the bed like I won. Talk like the wind in my chest to that sun. G5 in the U.S. to Taiwan. Now who can say that? I want to play back. Mama knew I was a needle in a haystack. Up on Valley Boy, plus way back. I got a feeling it's a rap. ASAP.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling. Yeah.
And that's just a little taster of what's to come this afternoon as we celebrate the 2013 Victorian season with the 2013 Victorian Premier League Grand Final. Bentley Greens, coached by Goran Lozanowski, going in against Northcote City Hercules, coached by John Anastasiadis. Legends of the game, don't forget our referee this afternoon, Lucien Lavari, will be the man in charge. Big responsibility on him. Dougie, you've been through some big games in your life. You've played in England, you've played in the NSL. This is, for these guys, for a lot of these guys, this may be, Dougie, the pinnacle of their footballing career. How are they feeling now as they prepare to come out for the biggest game of the season?
I don't know about you, Greg Blake, but they gave me goosebumps in my arms. That's the feel and the passion that you get when you've been a professional footballer and looking at what's going on at the present moment in time in this sort of atmosphere. They'll be down there in the dressing rooms at the moment. They'll be probably focused. I'd be thinking to myself, you know, what the game's about and what we're going to go through, win me headers, win me tackles, win me battle for the day, and then obviously you get addressed by the gaffers. Obviously Johnny A and Loza will be basically talking to the players of what to expect, basically getting them revved up, passionate. But I have to admit though, Blakey, on a field and a beautiful stadium that we are involved in here, mate, if you can't get revved up for that cup out down there today, you're not going to be involved in football.
Absolutely, absolutely. Let's have a look quickly. We'll run through the lineups. We've got Dougie Hodgson here with me, as well as young Griffo. And Griffo, we've already started to analyse the two teams, but let's quickly run through the lineups. First of all, for the Bentley Greens, number 21, Stuart Webster, the goalkeeper. Dominic D'Angelo in the number 2. Jack Webster in the number 5. Thomas Matthews in the number 6. Wayne Wallace, the skipper, number 8. 11, Christopher Kiusis. Number 13, Dane Milovanovic. Number 14, Aaron Wilford. 19, Liam McCormack. 20, Luke Sherborne. And of course, 35, David Sturton, another famous name from days gone by. And number 50, number 55, Ryan DeVries on the bench for Bentley Greens. George Meliaris, the goalkeeper. Jamie Diabru, Luke Pilkington, Stephen Hatzikotsis, and Nick Modafari are the bench players for Bentley Greens. Good lineup, young Griffo.
Yeah, very good lineup. I don't think there's many injuries in that particular starting 11, so they're definitely going to be looking to go forward and play with a lot of confidence.
And of course, for Northcote City, we've got the teams coming up, as you can see.
Number 20, Luke Sherman, and on the bench for the Greens, number 1, George Meliaris, number 2, Nick Barry, number 17, Jackie Diabrew, number 24, Lou Wilkinson, and number 37, Stephen Patrick-Crosson.
So we've got to step ahead of ourselves. So there's the Bentley Greens lineup, the one we preempted just a moment ago. But we did it brilliantly, and that's the main thing. It's Doug Hodgson, Greg Blake, and a little young Griffo on team. And there's the Northcote City team lineup. So they're the team lineups for the 2013 Premier League Grand Final, and there's a big contingent down there of Northcote City supporters just going off and enjoying the afternoon already, and that's what you want, is a bit of atmosphere and a bit of excitement about a Grand Final. I don't know about you, young Griffo and DH, but I'm pretty excited. I'm excited in ways I didn't know I would be on Grand Final day.
Yeah, Dougie just said the goosebumps are, you know, starting to boil. I think he's just about to take his shirt off and put a jersey on and run onto the field. That's how excited he is. But, no, look, beautiful weather conditions. You couldn't ask for anything perfect in terms of football. Wonderful surface. And I'm sure, you know, we're going to see an epic encounter between the two teams. We've got a good, as I said, Northcote contingent. Chani Hierakles. I can't pronounce it fantastic, but I'm sure we're going to see a very vocal support as well.
And, of course, for the teams that were in the finals that have gone bowed out along the way, South Melbourne, of course, spectacularly getting pantsed by Northcote City last week in the preliminary final, 5-0. So their supporters will be looking on as we get some action down in the touchline. There's the trophy that they'll be playing for. We had a handle it. We touched that the other day, Doug. I can proudly say I touched that.
We had that on the locker room there, Greg. We got it, I polished it and made sure it went back straight away to the FFV, but that's what they're playing for today. And let's be fair, it doesn't get any bigger than this is football, mate. You're out there, sunny day, playing on a surface in a fantastic stadium. You cannot expect anything out from this beautiful game of the code of football today. Goran Lozanowski, obviously winning Coach of the Year this year, which was fantastic. Lou Sherman, who was out there. Obviously, media player of the year. Obviously, we're getting a red card during the year. Literally, a boy who came over from the UK. Midfielder, but he's scoring some goals. So, I think he's had a great year. But, Griff, we spoke about one team. Let's go back into the other team. What can we expect from the other boys today?
Northcote, and they've been, as I said, they've had a lot of goals this year. Lewich, Kalafatidis, Piemonte. They've scored, you know... A lot of goals. If we look at other players in the team, they've been performing very well. Kalafatidis, Albradovic have been a fantastic solid midfield. Back to you, Doug.
Thanks, Griffo. Thanks, DH. As the two tides come out onto the paddock to the strains of Enter Sandman. Yeah, rock on. Sensational stuff. So we've got the Bentley Greens and Northcote City in their first ever grand final, and the referee, Lucien Lavari, standing in the middle as we stand for the national anthem. So the national anthem having been played, 2013 Grand Final day. If you can't feel it, if it doesn't move you, You've got something other than blood in your veins. It's grand final day and we are set to rock and roll here at Amy Stadium. Seatbelts on if you're watching over the internet. I reckon it's going to be a ripper. Griffo, prediction.
Prediction, I'm going to say North Kitten, a very close one. 1-0.
1-0 says Griffo. And DH, you've got your filthy grubby fingers all over this. Which way is it going to go? Slight wind down the ground. Will that have any effect? Two questions in one.
I actually think, Blakey, you know, I think everyone's going to tip Norfolk. They've had a great year. Can the bubble burst? Minor premiers. I actually think that, day like today, I actually think Bentley might pick it up in the pinches today with a little attacking midfielders that we can see out there. I reckon Bentley, 2-1.
First against third and 90 minutes to come to decide the season. And I know we talk a lot, you and I, Dougie, have had several heated discussions about the merits of first past the post or grand finals or final series. I, for one, advocate this stuff because this makes it, it brings it down to this. You decide on the paddock, you decide over 90 minutes, mano a mano, face to face. Bring it on.
I have to admit, Blakey, you see days like this, but you know, I've always been a philosopher. If you win the league, you've been the best team over the, you know, over the generation of the season, which I think it's fantastic. But you get an atmosphere here, what we're feeling at the moment, it's electric. I don't know about you, Blakey, but this is when I used to stand there in the centre half, look around the crowd, feel the atmosphere, and I used to say to myself, bring it on. This is what we do. This is what we do for a living. This is what the game's all about. Exorbitant, passionate, enjoy the game. It's going to be a great day. Like Blakey said, you fasten them seatbelts on. You've got the two captains out there at the moment. It looks like the referee's having a little word to them. Little toss of the coin in there from the skipper. Heads or tails, which way are they going to, which way would you go there, boys?
Wayne Wallace wins the toss, I think. For the Bentley Greens. And away they go. Which Chiappetta, in fact, won the toss for Northcote, but they will be defending the goal to the right of screen. I reckon that breeze, which is quite quite significant, it's blowing across the ground. Weather report, young Griffo.
Weather report, well, as I said, a beautiful sunny day here. It's probably building up to about 23, 24, up to about 27 degrees. As I said, the wind going from right to left. But that shouldn't really matter, the two teams. It's a beautiful playing surface and beautiful football expected this afternoon.
I love the subplot. And the subplot is, of course, John Anastasiadis, the coach of Bentley Greens, and Goran Lozanowski, coach of Northcote City, were teammates for a number of years at South Melbourne in the great NSL days. They won a championship together. And today they face off as coaches for the first time. For the biggest prize in Victorian soccer, team huddles at both ends of the paddock is Northcote. Just a little bit of team bonding, a bit of eye contact, baby. Give it up for the team this afternoon because it's all on the line, DH.
Tell you what, mate, Blake, it's the first time I've been told to turn the tone up. The boys in the locker room said, start talking a bit louder. I give you the tip, and that's they. You heard that live. Remember this, PPL Grand Final day. We're ready to go, Blakey, Gripper. Boys are in there, Northcote, having a little chat to each other. What would they be thinking? This is what it's about, boys. Let's get this game under the way. 2013 BPL Grand Final.
And I just wonder, having never had the experience that these guys are about to do, but just how much nerves can take their place on a day like this with something of such significance. Spit it out, Blakey, I will. Something of such significance on the line. It'll be Northcote City Hercules to kick it off, to get us underway as we get ready to rock and roll in the grand final of 2013. Northcote in the all blue, heading to the left of screen toward the city end of Amy Stadium. The crowd lifts its voices as we get away to a start with the referee, Lucien Lavari, the man in charge. Throw in to Hercules. We've been going inside a minute.
Looks like the start of it all. The boys of Bentley Greens have started with a 4-3-3, but merely a 4-3-2-1. Luke Sherman there on his own to be bringing some people into play from the wide angles. Ball through over the top. Out come Webster. Takes it nice and clean and nice and simple. Looks around, see what he's got. Looks like Bentley, 4-3-3, mate.
Yeah, I mean, it's just important to get an early touch, as you know, Doug. Just get an early touch in a grand final. Just get those nerves out of the system and just try and, you know, create some good passages of play as Bentley now they get into the attacking half.
So Bentley Green's getting to the front third for the first time. Great ball inside. Chance for score. Cut back. Bang! Over the bar by Bentley Green's. Wayne Wallace, the skipper, he'll be disappointed about that terrific opportunity, Griffo.
Wayne Wallace, that's a golden opportunity in grand finals. You've got to take that. That's, you know, just doesn't need much power there, Dougie. He just needs to place that, I reckon.
He's obviously, you know, I don't think we could say there was a bobble out there because the service looks quite well, Griff, you know. Balls came in, his third man running, great position. Lou Sherbs knocked it back to him. He's entered the penalty spot. Nice, relax, lock the ankle, side foot, mate. They're goals. They're opportunities. You'd be very disappointed with their Blake and Griffo.
Great incisive move. First, well, best of the game thus far from Bentley Greens. But the skipper just turns it over the bar. Northcote on the move. Sherbon goes inside. Great touch. Ball reefed loose. Green's come up with it. Wide left. This is where they did the damage last time. Kounavidis. Stop start. Goes against the number four from Northcote. Konstantinidis. I'm nervous too, Doug. You've lost the plot. Stay with me on this. I'll get my rhythm back. Spectacular in midfield, foul given away. It's going to go the way of the Bentley Greens. The referee is calling a player over. Griffo, what's happened?
Yeah, maybe just some contact there through D'Agostino, but it's just an easy foul. But Bentley, a very positive start. And Ryan De Vries again, he scored the double to get Bentley into the grand final, and a very, very good run down the left from him.
D'Angelo, right side. Good charge down from his opponent. He'll get the toss though. Inboard calling handball. That's Sherbon again. Bodied off the ball. It's an arm wrestle deep in Northcote territory. Came off a Bentley Greens player. No. The referee's called it the other way. It's going to be a toss to the Bentley Greens. D'Angelo goes a long way back, Dougie.
Looking at the start of it, Wilford knocks the ball over there. Aaron, big fella up there before, bit of a collision. But I have to admit at the moment, Blakey, Bentley Greens look like a bit more hungry for that, you know, turn a bit of physicality to start with on the ball. Bentley Greens is looking to play it into Sturton. Holds it up, plays it across the paddock. Captain looks over his shoulder. Can they get it out the other side? No, ball over the top with Sherbon. Straight into the hands of the keeper as we go again.
So Siddle. Sorry, not Siddle. Petropoulos. Northcote. Showing nothing up front yet. Good intercept. Bentley Greens away again. Have looked far more steady at the start of the game than Bentley Greens. Great ball stroke down the ground. Wide right for the runner. Sturton it is. Cross ball deep, far side, header back, great chance again, turns across the body, what a pickoff, what a goal, no, call, offside, wow, great stuff from the Bentley Greens, it ended up in the net, it was cannoning round like a pinball machine, in the net, call offside.
Yeah, it was a great build-up play there by Sturton down the right and a good square header, Sherbon on target. It was a good shot and Petropoulos equal to the task and the linesman coming to their saviour, Northcote.
Look at there, Griff. You'll be a bit goalkeeper there. That's paradise for keepers. You're going to put that ball about a metre in the air for a goalkeeper. He's going to have that all day. You know, their reflex stage. Get it on the ground or get it in the top pigeonhole. But that's two goals that could have been opportunities here for Bentley at the moment. But will they? Yeah, will it cost him in the end? Let's see how we go. Running into the game. Nice little tackle. Knocked out there. Linesman flags back into Norford's ball. That looks too much energy and emphasis to get to that ball very quick there, Blakey. I think the sun might take a bit of its toll later on in this game.
It's fairly mild at the moment. The breeze keeping it reasonably cool as Konstantinidis with the throw goes short toward the touchline. Ball just out of the stretch of De Vries, and Northcote will get another look at it. Konstantinidis again with the throw, this time about 10 metres deeper than he was. Loops it to the top of the box. Sherbon cuts it back, far post header over the bar. Best chance of the game so far for Northcote City. They finally strike a blow at the other end of the ground after two great chances for Bentley Greens early.
Just a little bit far-fetched there, the big fella, big centre forward came out. Done well to get the ball back stick. He raises it. The ball was coming up instead of going down, but opportunities arrive. He's gone to some good places in there.
It's good to see that opportunities are happening early days for both teams. I think we're going to see a really entertaining game today. And just remember, Lewic, he's been the danger player for Northcote City as they win a free kick on the edge of the area. And this looks like dangerous territory, doesn't it, Greg?
Kalafatidis, the man going to ground for Northcote. So finally, Northcote City, Hercules strike back. You see the free kick again. Another Kalafatidis, Lewic, some great names from days gone by. If you're an old fan of the NSL, it's a Northcote free kick. Mark it about a metre and a half outside the penalty area, 45 degree angle, hands on hips to take the free kick for Northcote City. I think it's Rojas. Or it may be Gasperas. Far post header again, goalkeeper got the reach, finger poke away, it will roll over the line and it will be a throw to Northcote City again. So they step up the pressure. It's been a good couple of minutes for Northcote City. We are nearly 7 minutes into the game. Scoreless, couple of early chances to the Bentley Greens. Got one in the net, was called offside. But it's been a frenetic pace to start the grand final. Gasparis gets the ball inside. Cleared away, the loping run of the number four, Konstantinidis for Northcote, got a foot to the ball, it's gone off the Bentley Greens player, Northcote, or it's going to be spotted as a free kick to Northcote City, just inside their own half. Michael Eager is the man, goes side to side, just starting to measure it a little bit. It's been a hectic pace to start the game though, Dougie. Both sides signalling their intentions early on. It's been a bit of a heart stopper already.
I think it's been great, Greg. You know, here we go. I'll take it away in a minute. Sherman on the ball, looking to play out wide. Has he got support? Yes, he has. It's just brought out a good opportunity. A little back flick into the midfield and there's a third man. Oh, Sherman. Great run in there from Liam McCormick. The ball wasn't released, but mate, it's been a great start. Going, mate, two goals, two, three opportunities for him. Good in some good places. I think this is going to be a great game going forward, mate, because two coaches love going forward. They're not sitting back and waiting for someone else to have a go. They're actually in there having a go themselves.
Hope you're enjoying the action live streaming on the internet of the 2013 Grand Final. Yours truly, Greg Blake, Doug Hodgson, and of course, young Griffo on deck, who is eager to get his opinion because he knows these players intimately. Well, not necessarily intimately, but he knows them very, very well. As the runner, Lewic, and he carooms that straight up into the terracing. And, you know, what I've got to say, Griffo, just quickly, there's not a bad crowd build-up for this.
Yeah, very tight. He's starting to build up very well. How many people do you reckon here, Greggy? Probably, I'd say up to...
At least 5,000.
At least 25,000. That's the, no, there'll be at least a good 1,000 here. Yeah, but, you know, beautiful conditions, obviously. People thought, no, let's go out and watch the football today. But touching on what we said before, especially Dougie, you would have played against Goran Lozanowski and John Anastasiadis, both very attacking players. You could probably tell us, you know, is there attacking influences, players, you know, filtering through as coaches?
They done well. We'll go back to the game. We'll kill a moment in here. We've got a great run in here from Talango. He looks up. He's just well done by the skipper. I think the linesman's pulled a handball there. You know, I don't know what he's saying there. The rules of the game. Did the hand hit the ball or the ball hit the hand? Let's have a look at this replay. There it is. Oh. Don't know what the linesman's there, but we'll go back in. We're in a great here earlier. Davey Sturton on the ball. Looking into the box. Whole goalkeeper's holding his box in the 6 yard. He's giving himself a bit of air. Would have liked to have seen a little bit more from the goalkeeper. They're slowly gradulating, holding on the six. Sturton, ball's whipped in, but missed the first man right over the back. Situation's going through there. Griff again, mate. I know us coaches, we don't have bad games from up here, but their opportunities are going to be attacking that ball.
Definitely, that missed everything. But, you know, it's good to see Bentley getting dangerous balls into the box. And unfortunately, no one on the end of that one to attack that. But early days, we touched on before, Bentley's passing game, it's very, very smooth, very, very good. Their transition up the park has been very, very, you know, it's very strong. And that's John Anastasiadis' strength as a coach and what he's instilled in the Bentley Greens the last couple of years, and that's definitely helped them.
10 minutes into the season decided with scoreless here at Amy Park between Northcote City in the All Blue and the Bentley Greens, both in their first grand final, and both have come out all guns blazing. It's like a six-gun shootout in the OK Corral as we get a throw into Northcote City. Best chance of the game to the skipper Wallace in the first minute of the game for the Bentley Greens, but since then Northcote have wrestled their way back into the contest. It is line ball as we speak.
So the referee still ruminating over who takes the free kick. Kalafatidis squares it for Chiappetta. Shot charged down. Chiappetta lopes after it. Get a second chance. Strokes the ball for Obradovic. Another famous name from years gone by. Northcote. Speculative ball. Too long. Away come the Bentley Greens. Great running. And he just gets clipped at the last minute. Does David Sturton roll spectacularly to the turf. And a yellow card to Hayden D'Agostino of Northcote City. The first of the game. 11 minutes into the contest.
Great football there, Blake. A little 1-2 touch. Sturton was away. Little check there. Did he need to do it? Yeah, I suppose. Wasn't intentional, but obviously just to check him out from going, because Sturton was, he was going down that flank with some speed. He was away.
They look sharp and decisive attacking down this right-hand side. This is where this will come from. Again, it's either D'Angelo or Wilford, the big fellow Wilford. He's a huge individual. Wilford steps into it, lofts it, sits well in the wind. Great header, brave header by the Northcote player. And it'll go away to Sophie. I've got there clamoring to get to the microphone. Griffo, Griffo, settle down, son. Don't grab me that way.
No, it's all good. Just remember Dane Milanovic there, just upending there in the foul. Dane played last year's grand final for Oakley Cannons against Danny Nong Thunder. Was a loser on that occasion. And in goals, Stuart Webster, as the three ball's coming, and it's well tied it up there by the centre back.
As the game gets underway, I just, you know, tactical signing. He's inside. He's played a great ball in square. Oh, it's going to be very disappointing, guys. Very disappointed with that cross. I've got no doubt Christian will. But going back to the, they went a short ball here. Big Alan, Aaron Wilford's from the UK. He's been here for a few years now. We had him at Dandy Fundy with Stuart Munro was there with him. He was a centre forward at his time when he played over the UK, banging in goals. And the big fella's got great tidy feet. His mum will be watching live now. He's seen it on Facebook. They're making sure. But what I couldn't say there, though, boys, was they've done a short ball. He's 6'5". Why isn't he on the box at the other end of it?
We've played 13 minutes in the grand final decider at Amy Park. Sun-drenched Amy Park. D'Angelo goes wide for the runner to freeze. Keeps his calm. Ball back for D'Angelo, takes a bobble across the box. But well done by Petropoulos, who swooped and gets the runner clear. It has been an engaging start to the grand final so far between the Bentley Greens and Northcote City. No score as yet, but it's like trying to decide between a crunchy bar and a violet crumble. You say to yourself, they're both delicious. I can't choose at this point.
I'd have to go the violet crumble there, Greg. I think that would probably taste a bit better. But no, D'Agostino doing a good number on Sherbourne there. Sherbourne, we all know, is a danger player for Bentley Greens today. He's their top scorer. And just done well in the box to shadow him off. And both teams now starting to settle on their rhythm as Northcote go forward. Now Chiappetta, the captain, has been fantastic this year. Kalafatidis in now. And the play breaks down. And Dano Milanovic trying to get in with a scrap. As Northcote now get another attack. Obradovic gets across in with his right foot. It's not a bad delivery, but it's controversial as a goal kick.
Yeah, looked like didn't look like that to me. But let's go to watch the. I've never worked with two co-commentators that are so eager to get their opinion. And Dougie was just punching me to get his point across. We're 15 minutes in, almost into the grand final. It's a gorgeous day. And I've got two gorgeous people joining me in commentary across the internet, Doug Hodgson and young Griffo, Griffith Master, as we reset with the goalkeeper from the Bentley Greens. That was a waste. It just sat in the breeze, took a skip across the line. Doug, Dougie Hodgson.
Did you call for that ball off Webby, by the way? Because I think he just about fanned you from there, Blakey. That was a fair strike. I just wonder if his mum or his dad would be sitting down there to try to hit him, get him on camera. Anyway, Sherbourne, Sturton, diagonal run in front of him, giving away easy. Nice little flick there by Adi, a little 1-2. Got little triangles going on, back to the keeper. Oh, yes, that's where he should have went. Obstruction given. Play on, says the referee. All the way out to Chris Lopez on the outside. Down now, mate. Starting to pick up. They came out at Norcus playing the 4-4-2. Or a 4-3-3 at stages and trying to push up high on the flanks. You know, obviously 4-3-3 in the same. That's why the game's going to open up here very quick and Blakey, because of the tactics the two coaches are going.
Kalafatidis has been terrific so far. He might be on the receiving end. No, safety ball then in the end from
D'Angelo, and there's going to be a corner to Northcote City, who have wrestled their way back into the match. Their fans are happy with their progress. They've been pretty vocal so far, the Northcote fans. It's been a long time coming for both these clubs, both famous clubs, Northcote City particularly, to finally reach this pinnacle of Victorian soccer. It's going to be a corner to Northcote City. Alex Rojas to take it for Northcote City. Hercules goes near post. The ball in the end jettisoned across the goal face and then over the bar. It's going to be another corner. So the pressure, the thumb screws on the Bentley Greens at the moment. They will be ruining, I suspect. That you wonder whether Wayne Wallace will be sitting back at some point and regretting that very, very early miss as Gasparis across to take the corner for Northcote. Two in a row, 17 minutes in, no score in the grand final. A leap from the goalkeeper, came up with all air. Bentley Greens will get away with it anyway. If they can launch something down this right-hand side, a big steal almost. Well played by Michael Eager though. He went once, he went twice, and it's a Northcote ball.
What game there, Blakey, would that look like? A Bentley ball made contact on the Northcote side. I hope we don't have a repercussion of last night's A-League game.
So Northcote City come again. Obradovic, great cross right to the end of the six-yard box. And reef clear again. The Northcote defenders, I'm just starting to feel like they are just getting a little bit flustered, aren't they, Griffo?
Yeah, they are. And also Bentley, I think they'll be just happy to get out of their own third at the minute. They're just sort of under the caution, trying to get this game settled a bit more. But again, we talk about turnovers, Dougie, especially, you know, as a player, you know, the most turnovers, the most unforced errors, you're going to be on the back foot, aren't you?
I don't know what a cosh is, Griffo, but I don't want to be under one, just from the way you've mentioned it. So if anybody sees a cosh, let me know. It's to be avoided at all costs. As Northcote City head forward again, we're 18 minutes old. We are goose eggs here at Amy Stadium Grand Final 2013, but it's been a rip snorter in this these beautiful spring conditions here in Melbourne. And it'll be a Northcote City throw. Obradovic again from this left-hand side, heading toward the city end of Amy Stadium. Gasparis launches a rocket straight into the groin of the big fellow Wilford. Cannons away for the Bentley Greens. I don't know about him, but I'm hoping he was wearing a box. There'll be bruises where there ought not be bruises this evening. Great wrestle for the football. Well played by the 16 as he goes to ground. Oh, penalty, you're kidding me. Wow, controversial. That was De Vries, was it? De Vries went to ground. The Northcote bench is up in arms. Let's have a look at that again. Can we get an interpretation on that? Dougie?
Mate, De Vries done very well. He's just nicked it. Looked like, I haven't seen the replay, but it looked like he just flicked the ball through the legs of the defender of Northcote, got inside on the wrong side of him. Obviously, he's came across, and he's obviously played. I couldn't see if it was a pen or not, Griffo. Looking at this penalty as it comes up, it's a bit of a soft one, I'm hearing from reports, but here we got, who's on there? Sherburn. Luke's going to take this, Sherburn. I'm tipping he's going to go. What side we got here, boys? Left or right? Give me a little bit of a bonus. As it's nice and quiet, making sure. Been penalties this weekend. Takes up the play. Looks to his left and it goes right and hits some bloke in the grandstand in row Z. He'll be very disappointed at that, guys. Was it soft? Was it not? Yes, it was. Or was it evident? But we have a miss.
Wow, this grand final, apart from a goal, young Griffo, at this point, it's had plenty of moments. We are only 20 minutes in. You would go back to the turnstile and say, may I pay again for the entertainment we've had so far?
Well, I can't believe it. Sherborne's just gone for power. And he's been the top scorer for Bentley this year. And why would you do so? He sent the keeper the wrong way. All he had to do was caress it and direct it, you know, with, you know, a bit more finesse. But anyway, 0-0, game on.
Well, let's just summarise what we have so far. 20 minutes in, the two best chances of the game going the way of the Bentley Greens. Northcote have been the better side, I would suspect, in general play, but Bentley Greens will be looking back on this with some disappointment as Sherbon takes on the goalkeeper. Well played by the goalkeeper. Harries him out of it. Sherbon with the chance. Goalkeeper out of position. Corner to the Bentley Greens. Heart Attack City. Obradovic with the last gasp defence concedes the corner. Trundling in to fetch the football is David Sturt. He'll go back and take the corner. We've had a penalty miss in the last couple of minutes. And now we get another chance with David Sturt in the corner for the Bentley Greens. We are scoreless in the grand final. We are 21 minutes old near post. Blind header across the goal face. And finally, Chiappetta, the skipper, puts it to safety. Now a second consecutive corner to the Bentley Greens. Has somebody got a heart attack tablet? Because I'm about to have one, baby. This is a rip snorter.
Petropoulos, was good goalkeeping from him, wasn't it? He came off his line, he didn't commit, he didn't concede the foul, and credit to him, he had to make a second save, and the defenders come to the Northcote's rescue again.
So Northcote City under the cosh as we speak, not knowing what that means. In swinging corner, dangerous, all air, comes up on the far side. Webster cross goal, think the goalkeeper got a touch to it, last gasp defence. Wow, this has undulated end-to-end stuff. And the referee, Lucien Lavallee, is going to call it Northcote's way. Wow. Hasn't this been a start to a grand final to remember? And my co-call is a wrestler. You guys have an arm wrestle and decide who's going to talk next. I can't deal with it. As there's a few questions. Goran Lozanowski, the coach of Northcote City, having a talk to his skipper, Adrian Chiappetta. As Northcote recalibrate and relaunch from the left-hand side of screen, the man under pressure, Kunivelis. And Dougie, you're gesticulating wildly. I don't know what that means.
That was a free kick there, Blakey. Boy, trying to get it. Mate, they've had some great opportunities there, Blakey. Like, that ball's gone across the six-yard box. Nobody's attacking the ball. You've got to get across the keeper. That's a rule of thumb as a striker. Pick the keeper, will take you to the ball. Get across the keeper, score your goals. No one's gone in there. They're golden opportunities there, matey. Northcote on the ball, whipped in, missed the first man out. Big Wilford wins the header. And he's far down here. Looks up, driven in. That's all the way to Webster. Has he got the legs? He'll take it cleanly. And the movement off the ball, he's looking for something. What has he got? Rolls it out. Have to admit, though, Griff and Blakey, the ball is not going long today. They are playing the short game as well.
It's been a ripper to watch as chasing back. Obradovic been busy in this first half. One of the standouts thus far. Northcote City again. Take out the micrometer. Make the calculation. Here we go from half field.
Will it be a day that Bentley look back and look at the chances that they had? Wayne Wallace in the opening couple of minutes and also the penalty.
As Wallace sets it forward. Good still. A free kick.
I think the supporters were quite happy about that, Blakey. I tell you what, I think these supporters are like to get him down to Tullamarine and see if he can start using that flag a bit more, because there's been a call a couple of times. The boys think he's been offside. He can flag a few planes in.
Halfway through the opening stanza, it is Amy Park in Melbourne, which looks an absolute picture on a delightful spring afternoon as we celebrate the Victorian 2013 Premier League season with the grand final. And it has been grand. It's lived up to its name thus far. It's been a beauty. Eager to the skipper. Chiappetta looks up, drills it long. It sits like a nine iron. Goalkeeper comes, takes it safely at eye height.
You've got to be whipped in there, Blakey. You know, as we say in goalkeeping, that ball's in the air a long time, which it was. They're Webster's ball all day long. He'll have that. They're cherries for someone of Webster's experience. It's got to be driven in. Movement off the ball. It's a stale, mate. I think we've stalemated it a little bit. It's just backing off a little bit. Or as Northcote just dropped off to another game plan and just letting them have the ball for a bit of a breather.
Well, for those of you that watch Star Trek, you can't stay in warp drive for too long, and that's the way we started the grand final. So they're just starting to perhaps feel the effects of a rim fire start, to be quite honest with you. Still no goals in the grand final. The best chances heading the way of the Bentley Greens. The pressure was on Northcote early on. They flip-flopped. It was on the Bentley Greens, and now we've just reached some calm in what has been a tumultuous sea so far. Milovanovic's ball headed clear. Obradovic, and away come Northcote. Chris Parson, five in a row. The skipper squares it. Seven passes. I'm counting the passes. That'll be 8-9. What are you seeing, Griffo? Just wait with this. That's got to be a free kick.
Elbow right in the back of the scone from the big fellow, Aaron Wilford.
Yeah, free kick, good 25 yards out, 25 to 30 yards. It's, well, with a bit of a tailwind, I wouldn't mind Dougie to see, you know, someone tee off here. Michael Eager looks like he's going to get behind it. And, yeah, I'd like to have a shot on goal here.
I'd like to see the target hits. One touch and strike. It was a good strike. It's gone back to Sherbourne to the 1-2. We've got some runners out wide. 55 Durham. Durago's gone up. He's got people in the middle. Can he play it one more? Can he cross it? It looks like we're going to have a goal. Great defending in there. The bodies are on the line. He's still got it. There's green bodies in there. Can he find someone? Yes, he no, he can't.
Gee, they will not come a lot closer than that. In fact, they will. They've already come closer twice. But that's not the point. Best chances of the game again. One of the best chances of the game to the Bentley Greens, but we still remain scoreless. It is like watching your kettle boil, isn't it, really? You know at some point you're going to enjoy a cuppa. You just don't know quite when.
Both teams can't buy a goal at the moment, and Ryan DeVries again, the most dangerous player on the park at the present moment. Fantastic speed down on the left. He got in on goal, but he couldn't quite, you know, get the ball, you know, to get a one-on-one with the goalkeeper, but he had a second opportunity on a fantastic square ball. As Northcote now on the attack, out on the right now, Christian Kalafatidis, he squares the ball in, and it's a weak shot by Kurnavalis, and another chance, well, chance, good chance for Northcote, but they couldn't take it.
Been the story of the game thus far as we head toward 28 minutes ticked away in the grand final. And if you're watching at home or streaming on the web, hope you're enjoying it as much as we are. We are aroused in ways that we can't even explain. It's Griffo, DH Dougie Hodgson, and yours truly, Greg Blake, calling the action. Very privileged to be doing so from this splendid stadium as we celebrate the 2013 season. And the Bentley Greens, as Griffin McMaster pointed out, I think at some point they may well live to regret two or three chances gone begging, really clear chances. As D'Angelo takes a look up, strokes the ball toward half field, Sturton, short and inside Milovanovic. Milovanovic to his teammate, stumbled over the football, they'll get a second chance from half field. The big loping Wayne Wallace missed that early chance. Can they make up for it here? No, they can't. Missed time pass. Kurnavalis toward half field. Good challenge. Kurnavalis will get a second chance at the bouncing football. 35, 30 metres out. Squares it. Goes outside for teammate. Oh, the brave header against the goalkeeper. Who was that? That was back Kalavatidis. The goalkeeper's gone down.
That's a great ball in. It's the unknown. It's the zone. He's gone across the keeper, which we spoke about before, Griffin Blakey. As it, hey, ball came in, I have to admit, he's gone across the keeper. It's blocked out Webster's view. If that had missed both players, that ball was going in the back of the net.
Well, don't need to remind me. 2011, James Kalafatidis one-on-one with me, and I come up and broke my leg. So that wasn't a pretty moment, but don't worry, I'm still standing. But I'll tell you what, he's got a big, thick-set body, JK, and I would have probably liked to have seen a foul on the keeper, because I am a goalkeeper and I like to think we're protected species. But anyway, Bentley ball.
They can stick the knees up, mate.
So 30 minutes almost away in the grand final. These two sides, the Bentley Greens and Northcote City, have played 10 times in Victorian Premier League competition. Bentley Greens have only defeated Hercules once all time. Wow. Air shot almost just off the side of the boot from Dominic D'Angelo. So that won't go on the highlights reel, I suspect, and it'll be a throw to Northcote City. On the left-hand side, Obradovic. Short ball back for the skipper. Chiapetta, unsure, waits for the challenge to come. Goes straight down route one. Wide ball again, Obradovic. Rojas inside. Easy away by the Bentley Greens. Wallace again, the skipper, loser. Just went a little bit too long for his liking. Northcote City, the through ball was almost there from Rojas. Again, charged down. Still got a stalemate. The game is on a knife's edge. Believe me, on so many levels. Long, speculative shot from Kurnavalis. Straight into the goalkeeper's arms. He got a good look at it early on. And they'll come away again. Milovanovic
for the Bentley Greens, and something happening off the ball. What me? We've got the what me.
What's happening is, guys, is hey, basically serve on the skipper. It's been going on for a little bit, guys. You could hear the crowd before going on. And basically, if they want to hold hands, they should go on a date, I think, these two. Basically, Adrian, the skipper there, and Luke Sherborn out there. Mate, what's happened is, before they're playing hands, the referee's had words, and then Adrian's grabbed, and then Luke's just pushed him away, and the skipper's played on a bit, and obviously Adrian, the skipper in there, Chipita, he just falls. Yellow card for Sherborn. You know what, to be fair, could have been a yellow the other way, but obviously retaliation in this game, Griffo, you can't do it. I've seen before, linesmen, and obviously the referees didn't, but unfortunately, it's a game of football, hands down, let's get on with the game.
Yeah, you don't want to see the referees ruin the game by a silly red card, you know, discretion off the ball incident like that. So I thought, you know, common sense sort of prevailed in that situation. I'm glad there's both 11 players on the park for each time, for each team.
So our referee, of course, the man that we're talking about, Lucien Lavari, is the man in charge. And to all intents and purposes, done a pretty good job so far in a pressure-packed game. And once again, you've got to say that this is terrific for the Premier League. Really good-looking crowd come in to celebrate the end of the season as Northcote City on the charge again. Kalafatidis, ball reef loose. Away come Bentley Greens. Kalafatidis gets another look at it. Short ball, ball scrambled. Goalkeeper comes bravely. Called it, went for it, got it. Did the goalkeeper of the Bentley Greens.
Wayne Wallace there turning over the ball there unnecessarily. Yeah, the ball just on the 18. I didn't know why he just sort of looked for a player to pass to or aim to clear it. And Dougie, what do you think?
I mean, a goalkeeper brave there by Webster. What I'm thinking of this game at the moment, gentlemen, is it's not moving. The movement off the balls, it's got a lot of static. There's nothing coming out wide. The opportunities, you know, the boys have got the ball in the 18-yard box. You've got no movement. You've got nowhere to go. Obviously, they're not the... Excuse me, you're not the team that's going to force the ball into the final third. They want to get it down and play. And unfortunately, if nothing's on, they can't play it. So this game's in a static situation at the moment. How long we got to go there? 33 played. We got not long to go. What's going to happen in the last 10?
So 12 minutes away from the end of the first half. As Dougie just pointed out, it's a Victorian Premier League Grand Final. That breeze continues to fluctuate. Coming in gusts across the field as Northcote City try to launch something from deep in defence. Gasperis. D'Agostino for Northcote. And the boys are sharing text messages. Please stop distracting me, boys, because we've got to call a big, big game. Lewis. Nothing doing. Top scorer. That's interesting, isn't it, that Lewis, the top scorer in the Premier League this year, really hasn't had a look so far for Northcote City as they come again. No goals in the grand final. Powered away by Jack Webster. Arm wrestle for the football in a figurative sense, and the referee's going to come in and call it Bentley Greens way.
Michael Eager definitely been one of the more dangerous players for Northcote on the park, and as I touched on before, Ryan DeVries, he's undoubtedly been Bentley's best player in the first half. Well, it's been I'd say Bentley have probably had, you know, a bit more chances than Northcote and been the better team.
I mean, Gravel opportunities, looks like they're coming off here. It could be a blood rule. Might be just a drink. Oh, we got a bit of a blood rule coming on, mouthful. Coming down into have a look. Anyway, back to the game, guys. Bentley's had some great opportunities, Griffo. You know, it could have been 2-0 up. Cleaner, better opportunities, but like I said earlier, this game's just stagnant. Sturton on the ball now. He could look to play in. It was there. Angelio was there. He's looked like diagonal. Has he hit it? Great defending in there by Christian Costadidis. Well done. Ball's back play. Can we get final? In he goes. Can he get it past? Well blocked out challenge. Heads up. What's he got looking on? Is he Greg Sturton in the middle? All the way through to Petrolopoulos in there. Mate, just seems that both teams probably going to be waiting for this half-time whistle just to blow that whistle so they can regroup and go again. But it's a little bit flat at the moment.
Yeah, it's the undulations of life being reflected in a grand final. Sometimes you're riding the roller coaster, sometimes you're having a cuppa and reading the paper, and that's right now what we're doing. Chased deep into his own corner was Aaron Wilford. Northcote will come up with it again. Ouch. Gee, that was an awkward challenge. That was an awkward challenge at best by Wayne Wallace, who hasn't had the best game
It hasn't had a memorable game. The man down on the paddock is Marinos Gaspiras, and I reckon he took that about ankle height, and it didn't look good.
Didn't look good. He looks like he's won the ball by the replay, but I could hear up in the grandstand here, we heard a bit of a clatter. I don't know if it was a shin pad or an ankle. Hopefully it's he's okay. Hopefully the boy gets up so we can get the 11v11 going again.
So he's down getting some treatment, Griffo, and the skipper of the Bentley Greens, Wayne Wallace. Not a game he's going to remember fondly to this point.
It's not, but you know, looking at the way he plays, he definitely puts his body about, and that's what it's that's what it's about being a holding midfielder. But I was just going to say, I've got a Bentley Greens player from last year, Scotty Bullock. It's his Buck's birthday today. A bit of a shout out to him, and I think he's listening to the live stream. But I hope you're having a good one, Scotty.
So if we are in fact sending personal messages, Tara Moss, if you're available tonight, I'm happy to catch up for a drink if you wish. It's a free kick to Faulkner. It's Alex Rojas coming in from wide left, a long way from the red zone. Lofts one, far post, goalkeeper comes, stretched at it, flapped his arms, couldn't quite reach it. Turned around the corner by Thomas Matthews, only to half field again though. Good contest, good physical contest. For Kunavelis it was. He'll get it back for Bentley Greens. Milovanovic. It's Sherbin chasing it down inside. Attacking territory in the corner will be conceded by Northcote City. So an electrifying start has come to naught as we head into the shadows of halftime at Amy Park for the grand final decider of 2013. 0-0 as Bentley Greens with the fourth corner of the game. Near post header away, glancing clear only to the top of the box. Again the shot charged down. Greens with the thumb screws, and again that time it was the skipper Wallace, and the ball charged away by Gaspiras, who was down just a couple of moments ago, but he looks for fit and firing again now, and it will be a Bentley Greens ball. Sturton waiting for his teammate Dominic D'Angelo. Wastes ball aloft, goes deep towards the touch, towards the goal line. The challenge is on, and it will be another corner to the Bentley Greens. 38 and 35 away in the grand final first half, Doug.
Sturton back on the ball here, Blake. Let's see, the Wilford up there. Big belt fella's making his way. Short run. Sherbourne, he finds Wilford. Header. Great defensive header in there. Kasagas with balls in a play. Wallace on the ball. Can he go past him? Oh, love, little love check. Boy, that's just a bit of hip and shoulder in there. Nothing wrong with that in football, but unfortunately when the boy's just about gone past you, it is. Now that's bad sportsmanship. The boys grab the ball, bring it over, gentlemen. You can actually give it back to him. I'm sure the referee will wait till he blows the whistle to get back in the place. As looking like Ryan DeVries is making his way over the ball again.
I reckon, I actually think, Griffo, they're starting to look a little bit tired. I reckon they have spent a fair bit in this first half. There's a laconic nature, as if they're winding it down to half time. What a great free kick off the bar. A ripper off the bar, and it cannons away to safety. But again, another chance. That was Pilkington, was Sherbin, was it? So Sherbin. So once again, Griffo, the better chances of the game, including a penalty, have been squandered. That wasn't a great chance. That was just an awesome free kick.
It was a very good free kick, and took Petropoulos off eye there, and I think he was trying to get his wall set as the ball comes to the middle of the park, out on the left to Gaspiras, and his move from South Melbourne's been very good. Transitions eager, tries to put a ball out onto the right. It looks like a nearly 50-50 challenge, and Webster is equal to the task and clears out to safety. But also, Dougie, you played in finals football. What about the mental lead up into these games? It can really take a lot out of you coming into these games.
I'm tipping though there, Griff. They've obviously, depends what training they've came into. It's just another game. If you can mentally switch on and basically keep yourself focused to that sort of game, but we'll come back to that in a minute. We're just underway here. Ray, just little cheeky trip over here, laid back. He's got some movement back into the head of Webster, clears his line,
flicked over there. Sherbin comes over into play. Centre half has made a mill. He's all over it. He's got in there. Constantinos is in there looking for his feet. Blake's in place with his feet. Little 1-2. Wallace into the midfield. Can he get his head up? What have we got? He's got nothing on. He's looking. Angelino, you've got to give me a better space out here, son. You got a left or right. You can't play through bodies, unfortunately. This is where it's breaking down on the right-hand side. You can see the boy just having a look over at the moment. Milanovic's looking over, saying, mate, I need you. Goes to ground. Cleaned up well there by the skipper on the ground at the other end. Final third. 5-6 minutes to play, Greg Blake.
We can see 41-14 off the clock in the grand final so far. 0-0 the score as the Bentley Greens get the throw. Matthews from that far side of the ground gets some distance on that. Brave header away. Northcote City only scramble it clear. Header from D'Angelo goes wide. Greens come again. Gee, they've come back after Northcote City came to life, kicked to life. It's been really mixed fortune so far. Bentley Greens again. The chip pass for Wallace, the skipper. He'll want to make good his first half. Wallace again, the ball for him is just touched away by D'Agostino. It's Hayden, and it will be a corner to the Bentley Greens as we creep deep into the first half. 42 gone. It will be a corner to the Bentley Greens. Liam McCormack saunters over to take it. Sees an opportunity. Scampers in the end. Opportunity closed down. He'll go back and measure up. Looking into the sunshine here at Amy Park. Glancing header. Difficult for the goalkeeper. And it loops onto the roof of the net. Coming from David Sturton. So we're still scoreless, Griffo, and the tension mounts.
Yeah, the tension, you can cut it with a knife. It's definitely electrified down here. Another chance, another set piece from Bentley. Sturton get on the end of it, and Petropoulos just, you know, looking at, over his far shoulder, and he'd be glad to see that one go over the top.
I'm not necessarily sure. They wouldn't be happy to go in goalless at halftime. Both these sides recalibrate at the interval, but Northcote, well, maybe they're going to have a say in that. Northcote City on the move. Cross goes deep, foot races on, and that should be a Northcote City throw into the last 2 minutes of regulation in this first half. Obradovic for Rojas. Should be turned over. It is. Charged down. See, the option was on then too for the Bentley Greens. Go for the big fellow. Milovanovic. Stolen by Obradovic. Weight of numbers releases back. They'll still get another chance to come again in the final minute before half time. Ball too long. The big fellow will let it bounce. No, he won't. Turns it away. It doesn't matter. It's called away the Bentley Greens regardless. And we've got a shoelace issue for Aaron Wilford, who has to bend a long way down to get to those shoes. He is a big lump of a man.
The thing is, I've always wondered about that situation. You know, is it an obstruction? Do you let him around? You know, the big fellas, the centre forwards, just got around Aaron in there. Basically give away a free kick. Man, was the hands? No. Did he win the ball? Yes. But, mate, we have got probably 3 minutes. We haven't got the minutes up yet from the third. Webster, he's got a mate over here. He kept it on the paddock into Sturton's head. Played in the road, just cleans up, head down. Plays it into the midfield. Looking at, have we got movement forward? No. Keeps the ball moving back into the midfield. Can he switch play? Yes, he can. Heads up. What's he got? Out of go. Yes, can it go out? Could have went about an hour ago. We're on a no standing. Come on, get that ball moving, gentlemen. Looking for movement. Sits it in, looks for a channel. He's gone over the top, overcome Webster. He'll just clean that up. Wasn't going the right way. Cleared up long, back to Sherbourne. We've got offside. Well done, the linesman. Basically, he's done well. We've got him to Tullamarine Airport. We've brought him back, and he's using that one magnificently up and down. The gentleman, mate, 45 times played. We're looking for some injury time, but that referee don't look like he's moving much.
No score here in the Victorian Premier League Grand Final at Amy Park. 25 frenetic minutes to start the game. A much more subdued last 20 minutes in this first half. We've got 2 minutes for time added on in the first half as the official holds the board aloft. Yep, we've seen it now. 2 minutes, thanks.
And what are we going to? What are they going to dish up in the last 2 minutes of this first half? I reckon they've done. They've got the cue in the rack now. They're ready to go in at halftime. See what the coaches have to say. See if there's going to be any changes made. See if they can have a significant shift in the time-space continuum.
Yeah, probably one more attack for either team possibly, but I think both teams are happy to get in the change room and settle, have a good talk on what's going on and how they're going to go about the second half. And I like to think that North could, as they start to go through James Kalafatidis now, and it's not the best cross as it goes over for a goal kick.
No, I've seen the best cross and that certainly was not it. We are into injury time in this first half, and it was a fabulous start to the game. The Bentley Greens have pounded at the door a couple of times. They've come a pounding, but they've been denied through bad luck, bad management and bad misses. And that's the way I think we're going to go in with goose eggs on the Amy Park scoreboard. It is a gorgeous stadium, by the way. The aesthetics of this place are absolutely a delight. As Northcote City to Eager, and the referee thankfully brings an end to what had started to peter out. The referee Lucien Lavardi has brought an end to this first half. There's going to be some tired boys out there. They went out there like a couple of sumo wrestlers, didn't they? They just ran at each other in centre ring and said, let's bring it on. They brought it on. The chances came. The skipper for the Bentley Greens. I mean, quite literally, the Bentley Greens have had the best chance. Let's just quickly look through. We're going to have John Fodinos in for the halftime wrap. We're going to go to the boys. But, of course, the skipper, again, Wayne Wallace, will go in at halftime and we'll rue that first-minute miss. They scored from an offside position after four. The young fellow, Luke Sherbon, oh, my Lord, a penalty miss. You don't see that too often. He scored three or four this year. And, of course, a free kick off the crossbar. So the four best opportunities of the game. Northcote City had its moments. It was, as I said, a thunderous start to the game. The crowd is revved up. Amy Park is gorgeous. Doug Hodgson, you're gorgeous. Young Griffo, not so much. Let's talk to the men who actually know what they're talking about here at Amy Park on Grand Final Day 2013. I'm still excited, Doug. Dougie Hodgson. So give us quickly your summary, and we'll throw to young Griffo, and then the halftime summary from John Fodinos.
Mate, that's, it started off a house of fire. Game's gone electric to start with. Teams that came out buzzing, which is what you want to see on a grand final day. But just as the game's gone off, I think, Greg, that they've dropped off a little bit, the thing. Actually, we're obviously analysing it from up here. In the wide areas, it's probably affecting them in quite some times. Like Angelo, obviously, I'd like to see a bit more moving from him from the right side of the area. In the first 20, 25 minutes, he was involved in the game a fair bit with Sturton. You know, Sturton's playing out wide right, Griffo, which, you know, could you see him playing out wide? You know, obviously you've seen him play inside out. I've seen him as a centre forward. I've seen that boy score goals. You know, he's a great prodigy of the player. What do you think about putting up Sturton out on the right-hand side?
Well, obviously John's gone for pace out wide on the right, and he's probably looking at his best options, and he's got very good pace out on the left with Ryan DeVries as well. So you're looking at the two combinations there. He's probably playing the best fit with what he's got. Luke Sherbourne, out-and-out striker, probably a bit difficult. Maybe you need a tall man to play alongside him. I'm not sure, but maybe with Sturton's pace for today on this type of surface, definitely be more suited out and to the right. Also, another thing I'd like to talk about, Dougie, is Bentley's midfield and transition in their passing. It's been fantastic. I mean, it really caught Northcote on the back foot and really got their defences a little bit at sixes and sevens. Talk about players like Wayne Wallace through the middle. They've been fantastic today, haven't they?
Wallace has done well, the skipper. I think he's going to have to watch himself. There's a little bit of argy-bargy going on there. He's on a yellow card. He's a physical player, as you know, Griff. He's done quite well. He's running it in there. I'd just like to see a little bit more movement from me, probably from both sides. You know, Northcote at that time, they'd let fly from about 20 yards out, which means the static up front, it's a little bit, you know, the movement off the ball. And I know I'm going on about the movement off the ball, but that's what's killed the game. It's made it flat because the boys have stopped doing what they were doing in the first 20 yards. You know, they do play it short, analyse it. Bentley's had some great opportunities. We've got Jay Podges, he's in here with us in the studio with us as well, Johnny. You know, it's been a great game, obviously, for Victorian Premier League. last 10 minutes was probably died down a little bit, and then we got a little bit more in the last couple of minutes. So the second half, mate, where do you think we're going to go today?
Good afternoon, Doug and Griffo, and also to Blakey. But what a start to the game. I mean, the first minute, Bentley with a golden opportunity through Skipper Wallace, and of course we talked about that and the penalty and all and the miss there, and just it's just been an amazing start to the game. The last 15 minutes or so did sort of die down as fatigue, I think, would have set in. But overall, I think Bentley probably be the side that's gone in a little bit more disappointed. They've had the better chances. They haven't taken them. And as you said on the call there, Doug, will it come back to bite them? But, you know, it's always a chance that you get one the other way. But Northcote, you've got to think Lewich, who's the gold medal winner, has just been well held. I mean, they just haven't really been able to break free there from him. So.
Well, Aaron Wilford's done a good job. You know, he's been quiet from, you know, but really, has he been quiet as a centre-half? He hasn't been quiet because he's done a great job. You know, has he been involved? He's been in some good challenges when he needed to. He's keeping the big fella. It's a good tussle from the two centre-forward and the centre-half.
Notice Northcote tried to get some attacking moves down the right there, but just their last pass into the box has been a big short there, and a couple of times they've given a couple of crosses that have just gone way too long. So that's been a bit disappointing. The service to
them. What we're saying is the final ball in the final third is actually letting them down. The movement, the big fella's got the centre forward Melos in there just basically holding the thing. So where is the early? The quality's got to be there. The movement off the ball in the final third's got to be there. And if it's not working, they've got to actually tactically, right, if that's not going to go, can we get the midfielders getting involved and basically trying to hurt the Bentley defence?
Northcote had Kalafatidis trying to make the runs from the midfield, but they just haven't been able to move the ball quickly enough. And I'm just thinking, Doug and Griffo, how do you think the week off, given the warm weather, how do you think the week off for Bentley Greens will hold them in good stead, or do you think that's going to make any difference at all?
Well, obviously Northcote had a game last week, Griff, as we were talking, about 5-0, you know. Wasn't an easy game, no. I suppose South Melbourne's not an easy task. CT has done a fantastic job since he's taken over at South Melbourne. In there, obviously the development of the players and getting them to where he got them was fantastic for South. But a week off is fresh league, as we know, Griff, a week. And I think, Jay Pot, I think we'll find in the second half, we'll probably see the difference in that week off coming into the second half of this game.
Yeah, a week off can really give you not just a physical freshen, but a very, very good mental freshen up as well. I like to think that, you know, if I was Northcote, I'd be probably a little bit concerned at half-time. I think, you know, Bentley, they definitely had the better chances in this half. And I said, Bentley's midfield for Milanovic and Sturton, and also with Wayne Wallace, I think they've been a lot more dangerous today. Lewich, you know, we all know, golden boot winner for the year. He's been very quiet. Wilford's done a very good job on him. I think Lozanowski's really got his work cut out here as a coach. He's going to come in at half-time and really try to rally his troops into the second half and see if he can get some momentum in the second half.
What moves do you think, Griffo, that Lozanowski can make, given that the fact that it's going to be, you know, as I said, the physical toll on Northcote, given the warm weather, also given the fact that Bentley has had the week off, you know, what moves do you think Goran would be able to make to try and stem the flow in the midfield there? Because, as you said, Bentley seemed to be holding the edge there.
Yeah, well, you look at what Loz has got, you know, coming off the bench. You know, he's got Piemonte, D'Agostino, Catalano, got Soulis. They're his main options coming off the bench. I like to see the ball, the players get a lot more service better into the last third. And Lewich, again, he's going to have to, you know, create some more movement in the box and get into more dangerous areas. Really, I think Northcote's best player in the park has been Michael Eager. I think he's done a lot of good things on the park. He's been mobile. He's made a lot of, you know, creative movement off the ball. And I just think, you know, the other players like Gasparis, and they're really going to have to try and offer a little bit more and get into the game a bit more and see if they can get more opportunities on goal.
That's a great analysis there. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, you're here at Amy Stadium. We're streaming live on Facebook and on YouTube at the Amy Stadium for the VPL 2013 Grand Final. It is 0-0 at halftime between the Bentley Greens and Northcote City in what's been a match just lacking in nothing except for goals. We've had opportunities in the first minute. We've had yellow cards. We've had penalty decisions. We've had people hit the crossbar. It's had everything but the goal. And as we look forward to the second half with Blakey and Dougie and, of course, our special comments man, Griffin McMaster, you're listening and watching on the YouTube channel the VPL 2013 Grand Final, 0-0 at halftime between the Bentley Greens and Northcote City. And back here at the ground, we're just waiting for the players to make their way back onto the ground after the halftime break. And we'll just hand over to Griffin McMaster for just a quick idea of what he thinks might happen in the second half.
In the second half, we all know the substitutions and the potential for extra time. We can't get too carried away. The game could possibly go for another 15 minutes each way after the 90 minutes. So I think both coaches, they'll be a little bit conservative, but they'll also be mindful that if any players on a yellow card or anything of the sort, they'll probably look to make a change or two. But I think if I was Bentley Greens, if I was Johnny A, I wouldn't be really looking to change much. I think they're going very good at the way they're progressing. If I was Goran Lozanowski, I'd probably be just a hint concerned. Maybe change their game plan a bit. Maybe they got to sit back a fraction and just sort of look to break very quickly, because Bentley Greens are doing a very good job of that at the present moment. And I think that's how the game is going to sit. But I don't think we're going to see much change in terms of substitutions. But second half with the heat starting to get a bit warmer, it's going to take its toll on its players maybe looking for an element of time wasting and all that type of thing, just to try and get by in these conditions. But really, you can't complain. It's fantastic conditions out there to play.
It's often been said, if you can't play on a day like today with beautiful conditions out there, perhaps a bit of wind, but that's not really affecting the play too much, and the pitch looks an absolute treat out there. If you can't play football on a day like today, I don't think ever will be able to. Now, the only thing I wanted to ask you, Griffo, do you think Northcote were a bit overawed early in the early phases? Because it seemed to me like Bentley Greens just came out with all guns blazing and Northcote just really looked a bit shell-shocked, and we had that incident there, of course, where Petropoulos had to come out and make the double save. They just looked at a bit sixes and sevens at the back four there.
Yeah, I think they did. Definitely. The first minute, Ryan DeVries has got a lot of pace down that left, and he created a very, very good opportunity on goal. Wayne Wallace, I think he'd be looking back at that, what he did, and thought, I could have done a lot better. I like to think that, Northcote, as I said, the game plan has to be a little bit better in this second half. But look at the chances. We've got the penalty. Sherbourne, he went for power. There was no reason for him to really go for, that particular type of loft.
Missed by quite a margin in the end. Looking at the replay, the penalty kick is well wide. And that's been the problem with Bentley. They really, apart from the disallowed goal, they really haven't made Petropoulos make the saves. They've had a couple of gilt edge opportunities, but they haven't forced the keeper into save. And that's probably been the only real disappointing thing from the Bentley Greens point of view.
They have had a few square balls that have been a little bit dangerous in the area. Remember, one Sturton got a very good square ball down the byline, and Petropoulos got a touch, and that was a particular dangerous time for... But Petropoulos, he made one save to his right, but it was a nice height for him, but then there was a resulting goal that was offside. So he has been busy, but he hasn't sort of been outstretched in any regard, hasn't he?
And from the opposite end, Stuart Webster has been tested a couple of times, but has pretty much held sway there. As Northcote look, I think, to probably get the ball into Lewich and exploit his height there at the back. But you've got Aaron Wilford there who's held him well. So from a Northcote point of view, you'd be looking to try and get the ball in a lot quicker and try and isolate Lewich there with the defender rather than allowing them time to get back on him.
Yeah, undoubtedly, and Bentley's back four have probably been a lot more sounder
this half. They've been a combination that's played with each other, I think, for now three seasons in Webster and Wilford, and obviously Wallace just in front of him. I think D'Angelo, the right back's been there at the club for a number of years now, so it goes to show. Yeah, it goes to show when you do, as you just touched on, very settled, and when you gel over a number of years, you can really get a very sound combination going. We've got, the same's got to be said for Northcote. They've been in the same boat as well. A lot of these players have played with each other now for 2-3 years, and as I said, it's ironic that both these teams got promotion into the VPL into the 2010 season, and here they are squaring off in the 2013 Grand Final.
Thanks for those comments, Griff. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, remind you, you're on the Locker Room on YouTube channel, and we're just waiting for the players to make their way back onto the pitch for this second half of this 2013 VPL Grand Final. Shortly, we'll be handing it back to the main commentators, Doug Hodgson, and of course, the one and only Greg Blake, for the exciting second half, and hopefully we will break the deadlock in this game. But just once again, I'll just throw to Griffo just to get his idea of how he thinks the heat might play a factor in this game, because as I said, the temperature's heading up into the low to mid 20s, and of course Northcote have had the week last week where they played against South Melbourne in the preliminary final, whereas Bentley have had the week off, and of course they probably feeling that they're a bit fresher and able to run the game out a little better.
Yeah, definitely both sets of teams, they won't be used to these type of conditions. A 27, 28 degree day is a rarity in Melbourne, especially throughout the autumn and the winter months. So that will definitely play a key factor for these two, two sides. The most fittest team will prevail at the end. If you want to look, Bentley had very, very sound results in the second half of the year. So it looked like they've had a lot of legs coming into that part of the season, whereas Northcote, their results have started to dip. But it's 0-0, and hopefully the second half will bring out an enticing encounter.
Griffin McMaster and John Fotinos with all the half-time hullabaloo in a tied grand final at the interval. It is scoreless here at a gorgeous Amy Park. The shadows just starting to creep across the pitch as we head into mid-afternoon. It is a beautiful stadium. It's a beautiful setup for a grand final. You start the pre-season, there's that beautiful shot of Amy Park, a panoramic view across this wonderful purpose-built stadium. We've got 45 minutes to come. Here's the setup for you, Dougie Hodgson, my co-commentator this afternoon, baby. Here's the setup. You start your pre-season, you work through your pre-season, you have your trial games, you have an arduous 22-game season, you have 3 or 4 finals matches, there's 9 months of your life gobbled up, and it comes down, baby, to this. 45 minutes to decide the fate of the season.
And I'll tell you what, these 45 minutes, Greg Blake, will it change Bentley or Northcote's wall in the club rooms? Because one of these people is going to take one of these beautiful cup home today. How are they changing? No changes alive here at Amy Park. Greg Blake, referee, just about to start this next 45 minutes of the Victorian VPL 2013 Grand Final.
And the referee with a nod, a wink and a grin gets us away to second half action. The Bentley Greens in the green, ironically enough, heading to the left of screen. And of course Northcote City heading to the right of screen after a scoreless first half here in front of a terrific Premier League crowd to decide the season. Northcote tracking back. They spent a fair bit of the first half doing that. They'll get the chance to run and release from the back half. Gasparas to midfield. It's been awkward and it's been stilted for Faulkner for long periods, and they've spent a lot of time in their own half. Big giveaway. De Vries for Bentley Greens runs crossfield, waiting for an option. De Vries on his right foot, toe pokes it wide. He'll get the chance coming in. Sherbon, square ball. D'Angelo pummels one. Goalkeeper saw it early, took one hop straight into his eager grasp at that city end of the ground. Booms one into the front half for Faulkner. It's going to be too tall for the jumping Kalafatidis. Greens will come away. Man on the left-hand side is McCormack. McCormack goes round the corner. Has it got the angle? Not quite. And pummeled away by Hayden D'Agostino. We are in the early moments of this second half. Grand Final 2013. And we are scoreless here, Dougie Hodgson.
Yeah, well, it's the same as the first half. Greens have come out. Tony Early, as you just said there, Blakey, mate. But Greens, long throw in. Ball's been thrown into the 18-yard box. There's a flick on. Skipper's up there to take it. Gets it back down to Rogers. Looks in the side. Hits his striker. Gets it to his feet, can he? No, it's a late one. We get a clash. Yellow clashing in there. And he's basically gone in there for a yellow. The referee's got it out. It wasn't quite malicious, I'd actually say. There is a challenge there, guys. Referee's gone in and a yellow.
Well, need I remind you, James Kalafatidis, he's very, very big boned, and that looks like a nasty challenge on Jack Webster. And he's down for the count at the present moment, getting some treatment. And it was a very late challenge, and it's interesting to see what referee Lavari comes up with, but I'd probably just like to think a yellow card, but interesting to see what happens.
And the player is still down and getting treatment, as you can see. Some concern over his condition. He didn't look good, Dougie, and we heard it up here, and there's a substitute awaiting possibly a change. As the treatment continues, who's the player down, Dougie? Did we pick him up?
Jack Webster is the player down at the moment. And as I told you, James Kalafatidis and I entangled I broke my leg. So it's not surprising that JK's at it again.
So thank goodness for that. Jack Webster is up. He's going to be a little bit ginger for a period of time. I would have thought that was going to sting, and he will feel that tomorrow morning when he's in the ice bath, and he'll need one. I can tell you right now, it's a Bentley Greens free kick. We've lost about 2 minutes. But you can just tell how committed they were in the challenge. Doug, I have no idea what those hand gestures mean. Liam McCormack lining up with the free kick from a distance. Goes deep. Blue shirts back. Ball popped in the air. McCormack will get the leap against Cunavalis. Great ball, or is it not quite? Just didn't quite have the micrometer adjusted well enough as they come again. Oh, Northcote City that time. That was McCormack on Cunavalis. And I suspect, as the referee comes across to have a chat with the protagonists in the event. Well, it's getting a little bit willing to start the second half. No big pardons. It is a grand final, buddy.
That's good to see, though, Blakey. Both teams are out there. They both switched them lights on and we're home. Let's see what they can pull out here. Mate, now, it was a little lovely. He's gone across him. He's checked him there. Actually, wasn't malicious at all. Here we go. Ball's being played in this final third. Webster's keeping him on the 18-yard box. Plenty of space for him to attack. He's having a level look in there. Get a smart. He knocked the ball in. Misses the first man out. No, it doesn't. Wallace is in there. Is it Wallace? Not too sure. It was Webster. That ankle's moving okay. Clear for a header. Got to miss the first man out in there, Blakey. That's got to go into some danger area. Short throw. Early. Backs it down. Can he get it down the wide? Yes, he can. Turns. Looks. Can he deliver? Great challenge in there by DeRubio. DeRubio's has done quite well in there. Keeping him going solid. Northcote looks like it at the moment, mate. Oh, see, I don't see that, Blake. You've got the ball rolling. They're in there. Get the ball moving. They've killed it. They've took the pace out of the game. Down the ball. Cleared in. Into Webster will have that. No, he won't. Little tip over. Greg Masters, goalkeeper. What was he seeing there, my friend?
Bit of a tricky bounce there for Webster, but Gasparis, we also got to note, boys, Gasparis and Tom Matthews play for either team, both taken out of South Melbourne. And here they are playing in a grand final today.
So Northcote take a stride back into what has been an engaging contest. Gasparis, Marinos Gasparis with the corner for header. Northcote. Header! Tipped over the bar! Great chance for Northcote City. Best of the game, I suspect, for them. Let's have a look again. Corner rifled in. Great leap and touched over. They'll get another corner.
Unmarked there, Blakey, though. Very unmarked. You can't let someone like the powerful of that header go in there. Great ball in, driven. Nicely floated. He's attacked the ball, but then again, unmarked. I'd like to see who was marking in there. We're on this one. Second corner.
Alex Rojas with the corner for Northcote City, big leap at the back post. Players go down, ball out of play. It will turn over and they will get to restart from their end. The Bentley Greens, it's scoreless. Griffin McMaster.
Webster, we've got to remember, Keeper of the Year last year was very solid for Danny Nong Thunder when they won the treble. And I'm just glad that his concentration was up to standard there for those two particular occasions. Two very good saves.
So the referee, we'll go back to that one, stutter steps on the edge of the box, almost outsparted himself then, was Sherbon. Looked pretty for a little while, and we've got to apologise, Lavadeur, not Lavadie. Lucien Lavadeur, apparently, is the correct pronunciation. My apologies on behalf of the team, and the referee's been special today. Done a great job under pressure. 52 minutes into the grand final. Almost a turnover. If he can just collect the football, the runner was Wayne Wallace. It's going to be a free kick, though, Faulkner's way. Midway inside defensive territory. I said Faulkner, it's actually Northcote City. Faulkner in about Division 9 now these days. As Bentley Greens awkwardly around the back half. Milovanovic goes wide left for Webster. Back for Webster.
Little 1-2s they're playing, Blakey, the two of them. Little game between themselves, bit of touch football. 1-2, 1-2, my kick, your kick. But anyway, we're back into it. Wallace, he's got little ones inside. Come on, boys, we'll only see a bit more penetration going on there. Wilford on the ball, out to Webster. Can he get it out wide here? Early on to Thomas. Thomas is there, too late. Got to be pushing it early. Now he's came over to midfielder, just moving the space over. Ball's got to be quicker, boys. Got to be a lot quicker.
It's got to be said, as we look at the start of the second half, rather more subdued than what we still saw at the start of the grand final. Handball called against Northcote City. But, yeah, really interesting contrast in the way this second half has started, Griffo.
A couple of early chances for Northcote, which is what they really needed. We knew Bentley were the better team in the first half, and I'm sure Lozanowski has gone to the halftime changes, had a word with a few of the players, and as Bentley play along the back with Webster.
So it's a Bentley Greens with the football inside their own half. Not now, they're not. It's McCormack, through ball, threads it. Great through ball right across the face, stretch for it. In the end, it was Sherbon. It's going to be what offside. The flag went up. Gee, that was a great ball through. I'm not sure that was.
Offside to me, Greg Blake. I tell you right now, looking at that picture as it went through on that replay, he was about a yard inside. I tell you what, we might have to have a look at the referee and see who we're going to send him, because Tullamarine's no good.
So we're looking, are we starting to consider, even at this early stage, 10 minutes into the second half of the grand final, Amy Park, where the score is Bentley Greens 0, Northcote City 0, first against third in the grand final decider. Are we starting to look at extra time and pens already? Because there's no suggestion that this deadlock's going to be broken easily. It may take a moment of mastery, of magic, of wonder. As Greens come clear again into no man's land. Played for no one. Found him with meticulous accuracy. And it's going to be Konstantinidis to take the toss. About 5 metres inside his own half. Takes a careful look. And Greens will come away again. Again, can't thread the needle. Arm wrestle, referee will call it, against Konstantinidis. And the Bentley Greens will come up with a free kick way outside the target zone. But inside their own half, no chances for the Bentley Greens to start this second half. We're 10 minutes in. They have had the best of the chances, Dougie.
McCormick done quite well there. He got his body in the across the ball in line. He's a bit of a battle in there, and I actually would have liked to see it played on. The referees pulled him up when they was just about to get the ball out and play. Little shuffles going on down here, Blakey. Handbags at 10 paces. I think a bit more spark in this game is starting to fire. I'd like to see a goal score, because I'll tell you what, it'll change it even more dramatically.
It's going to take a change-up from someone to get a goal to open us up, I suspect. as Bentley Greens retain tenuous possession. Free kick as the man down was Liam McCormack. Got one around the ankle. So Bentley Greens again get to restart from inside their own half. Milovanovic takes the easy option inside. And again, Dougie Hodgson calls for a switch. He's got a man wide right, but Lexter goes down the middle. Wallace, the skipper. They finally pick the outside option. Bentley Greens storming forward. Ball takes a cannon. Blues from Northcote should come away with it. Man down. What a scrap. This has been a really scrappy start to the second half. I don't want to be overly critical. I know the grand final's on the line. I know there's a lot of nerves. I know we're on a knife's edge, but it has been a scrappy start to the second half, Griffo.
Very physical encounter, isn't it? And generally these VPL games are very physical in general. But, yeah, definitely. We've seen a lot of free kicks, and we're also seeing Northcote had two pretty good chances early on.
Not quite reached 27, I suspect, as the Bureau of Meteorology suggested this morning. Still a warm day. Look at a terrific crowd here at Amy's Stadium for the grand final decider between these two sides who have never won the big one. And today, one of them, regardless of how it transpires on the day, one of these two teams will win the Victorian Championship for the first time. It is Northcote City on the roll. Gasparis finally elects to push the ball wide. Constantinides. Gasparis again. Undecided. Looks up the middle. Again, the easy ball, the lazy ball. Cross field. Eager to the man outside. Dances through two. Back to Eager again. This time down the middle. Top of the box. Cunavalis, nowhere to go. Undecided again. Nothing to break the lines, nothing to break the Bentley Greens open. Again, it's Gasparis, man in the box. Can't bring it down. That was Lewich. Reef clear. They'll come again. Another chance, half chance anyway. Turned across the body to safety by Matthews. Away toward the touchline. Out of play it'll go, and it'll be a throw in, Dougie.
Davey Stern there, obviously a bit of sun in the shine. That clearance had snow on it the time it came down. Mate, it's just a bit static at the moment. They're not penetrating through. The Greens are quite, Bentley's just quite happy. He can have the ball in front of us. Can they get a run of play? Can they get against play? Webster clears the ball out for a throw-in. What are we going to go here, Griff? We're in a final third of Bentley Greens, Northcote. Can they pull something out here in this little opportunity of the going forward, mate?
You talked about the static movement, especially from Northcote, Dougie. Do you think that Northcote just a bit flat in that final third? They just trying to rely on Lewich, and he's been a little bit quiet.
Wilford's done a great job on him, to be fair. He hasn't gave him a sniff of breath there, but as we know, someone of this calibre, give him a minute and he can do some damage. Rogers back into play, cleared away, and his far as Sherbourne holds the ball up. Defender right behind him, man defender again, ball's in the middle of feet. They're into it. Can we? Yeah, ball's being played out. What we got? Ooh, let's go. Green ball. Can we get the tempo? Tempo's... They're slowing the game down, buddy. They need to quicken it up, quicken it up. Long throw over the top. He's away. He's in there. Ryan DeBries. Can he get a cross in? Heads up. Pass one player. Two. Can he pick someone out? No, he can't. Northcote controls. Coutinho's looks down the line. All the way to Matthews. Little push hands. He's there. Ball out for the throw in. Can he play it early? Boys off the paddock. Yes, he can. Oh, sloppy. Got to get the ball back there. Come on, son. Expecting better from you. Webster, great header. Back into the final third. McCormick holds the ball. Bit of a love up there. Hands and legs are going everywhere. Rogers, can he get it out? No, he can't. Oh, hip and shoulder. Love it. Bit of a lover's tiff. Go on, boys. Let's get into this game. Let's temper though. City, can we kill? Oh, what we got, referee? Oh, what are you thinking there, mate? The game is flying. The ref's gone the other way. Fair enough. Bentley Greens going into this final third. We're up the other end of the paddock.
We're an hour old in the grand final, and it's still scoreless as the loping runner, D'Angelo. That's Dominic D'Angelo. They'll get moving forward, away again by a desperate Northcote City at the moment. Well controlled by Milovanovic, and he puts that way, way, way off the mark.
I think he'd be disappointed there, Blakey, with his tech knee there, my friend. Should have been on the target at least.
And the grand final decider that promised to be all action is at the moment going through something of a subdued phase. My good friend Young Griffo sitting with me, hoping that something will happen, gripping me with anticipation. Speculative long ball forward, chased back by Jack Webster, under pressure Webster. It's going to be a throw to Northcote City. Kalafatidis will take the short toss. The short throw, I should say. They'll reload again. Arm wrestle again. D'Angelo pushes his opponent toward the line. It'll go over the line. It's going to be another throw. Gaspidis. Rojas. Still nothing. Defending with some aplomb at the moment, the Bentley Greens there. They haven't been troubled. Great run. Turn around the corner by Canavales. Into the box. Canavales. Left foot. Oh, wow. Deflected in. Canavales is going to claim it. Came off Webster, I think. But Canavales has put Northcote City Hercules 1-0 in front. We are 62 minutes old in the grand final. Huge celebrations from this historic club supporter base. We want to see that one again and just see whether it was, in fact, an own goal. Griffo, your thoughts?
Yeah, took a deflection. And Jack Webster, I believe. And, the ball's in the back of the net. And it's 1-0 Northcote. Bentley, they were the better side in the first half. But Northcote, they've turned things around. And they've got the lead. And now Bentley are chasing the game.
Wow, what a way for it to happen. It has been a day of mishaps, mistiming and missed opportunities for the Bentley Greens on every level. It's almost symbolic. It's almost symbolic of the game so far that they go behind to an own goal.
You'd always count that was going to happen, Blakey, wasn't it? You always knew, obviously, the team that's always pushing forward. Looked like they're scoring. The opposition's going to always go up there and bang one in. That was banging. But, mate, we're back in this game. This is going to change the game. Ball's being played in. Angelina, long. Ball's driven in. Far post. Has he cleared it? Yes, he has. Out it comes out here wide. I'd like to say, Blakey, this game is going to change. We have now got a game on our hand here at the 2013 VPL, buddy.
Well, it still comes back to, doesn't it, very much the fact that the Bentley Greens have had every opportunity to underscore their dominance in this game. They haven't. And now they are going to regret it. The stadium announcers called the goal to Evan Canavales. We are calling it an own goal. Either way, it doesn't matter on the scoreboard. It's Bentley Greens 0, Northcote City 1 in the grand final of 2013. Amy Park is the venue for this game into the closing moments of the 2013 grand final and the season. Great nutmeg, double nutmeg, through for the runner and a great last-minute clearance by the skipper, Adrian Chiappetta. They almost got there by guile and perhaps a touch of luck, but it was a double nutmeg on the way into the box. They'll come again, the Bentley Greens. Now they are chasing the game. And as you said, Dougie, and as I'm sure you're thinking, Young Griffo, that's the game changer. That's when you have to reconcile what the game situation, and it has changed markedly.
You've just got to remember, this game is far from over. It's still going to be on. Bentley is still going to have a lot of attack. And again, Ryan DeVries, a danger man. Tom Matthews there getting an opportunity on goal. But as I said, we're going to see a lot more opportunities from now until the end of the match.
So it's yours truly, Greg Blake. It's Doug Hodgson and Griffin McMaster and the rest of the team here at Amy Park for the broadcast of the grand final of 2013. Northcote City currently around about 25 minutes away from a groundbreaking championship in Victoria. Up by 1-0, thanks to a 62nd minute strike, whether it was Evan Canavales' shot or the deflection off Jack Webster, it's still a goal. And here they come again, Northcote City. Does that charge them with some degree of confidence? They'll get the adrenaline shot from that, there's no doubt, because the Bentley Greens looked to be defending fairly well as referee Lucien Lavadure calls a free kick.
I think he's just about to have a walk over to Mr. Lozanowski, coach of the year, to have a little word. No need, settle it down, finish. I'm in control out here. And to be fair, he's done a great job. He's done a great job, he has today. So obviously, Loza, 1-0 up, frustrated, yes,
maybe not. You've got to be happy with that at the moment, mate. But we're away. Ray just on the ball. What are we going to do? Short. Waiting for him. Was there a yellow card there, Mr. Blake?
Substitution. Player off. Number 35.
Davey Sturton is coming off. This is for Jamie Jabiru is coming on there on the right-hand side, you know. Is it a great move? I'd like to see Sturts up front, to be honest with you, with Sherbourne. Obviously, I know he's a striker and a very good one and is capable of scoring goals and does a great job. There's only one hand, says referee. Plays on. Karachus is out wide. Looks in. What's he got in? Dangles inside. Rolls the ball. Little roll-up. You can't have that much time on the ball. Playing in little triangles. Two versus three. 3v2. Now we've got another inside. McCormick comes and play. Keeps his hands down, holds the ball up well. Good centre forward, good movement. Third man running, finds Rogers, holds it back outside. Can he deliver? What's he got in the box? Man back stick if he can find him. But into Webster's hand that will take it nice and clean. Webster rolls it out to Angelino. I'd like to see Angelino a bit more in this game. He wasn't the first 15-20. He's basically stepped down a little bit. Can we get him involved? We need him in Bentley Greens' team if they need him to go forward. Plays in his fine Sherbourne. Cut out there, followed up again. What's he got? He's got Wayne down right-hand side. Can't see him. He looks up. Back stick again. Oh, bad clearance there. Hits a Sherman, finds it back, and we have a goal. Yes, we do. We have a goal. 1-1 here, Ryan DeVries. What a great little finish. Bit of luck there by Bentley Greens down the right-hand side. We must take, but they will take it all day long. I've got no doubt at all. You can see DeVries finish. Cross the goalkeeper. We spoke about it early. Got to get across him. Sherman, nice cheeky ball back. Gets in there and finishing off. We have a game on our hands now, Griffin Masters and Greg Blake.
I was just going to mention the substitution for Bentley. Sturton come off, but Deabru, very good engine. He made that run down the right. Not a bad ball in. And we saw Sherbourne. It was pretty much created from him as well because he put a very dangerous ball in. And again, we've talked about this guy the whole match. Ryan DeVries, fantastic to get on the end of it. 1-1, and it's game on. This is an exciting game, isn't it, Blakey?
An absolute ripper, and we're back on level pegging. It's just like reading a Harry Potter book. You just say, what the hell's going to happen next? Who thought that? As we go 66 minutes in to the grand final of 2013. We're locked up again at 1-1. Two goals inside 5 minutes has set us up for a grandstand finish to the grand final. It's the Bentley Greens, Wallace the skipper. He'll be pleased about that. He's got to get out now. They're back on 1-1. Big steal by the runner. Michael Eager looks up. Stutter step run. Nowhere to go. They'll go again. Gasparis. Eager. Have to recalibrate again from the back half. Rojas. Long. Speculative. Bouncer. For the runner, Lewich. Top scorer in the Premier League this year. Nothing today. Gasparis had a second look. Obradovic measured it from long distance, top of the box, green shirts everywhere, ball to ground. Rojas through the milieu and a shot cleared off the edge of the six-yard box. That was Kunivelis again. And we're still at 1-1. He's been really, really damaging and busy.
Great little turn there, ball being played in, great strike by the midfield, little roll back, little shimmy turn, disappointed didn't hit the target there, was a great football. We're back in the play, McCormick on the ball, little 1-2, we've got lively movement here. Has he got runners? As Sherbourne pulls away, what's he got? Can he penetrate through? Plays into the McCormick again, they've got 4-5, plays it out wide, DeVries, and he's got it! And a great save in there by the goalkeeper of Northcote City. Well played. The boys in the box will be disappointed. If you have a look at the screen, it's been played. There's boys screaming across in the far. But would you be putting that ball in there? Yes, I'd be going and have it. Griff, goalkeeper, that's cherries for you guys. That should be on the deck there, mate.
Yeah, very easy pickings. But too much of a nice height, wasn't it, DH? You can't put it at that particular height. If he went low and low and hard, then you know would have had a lot more chance in saving that one.
Liam McCormack with the corner. It's one each and we are starting to wind up the way we went up the start of the first half. It's coming from everywhere. The back post header. It did in fact hit the post. The ball is running loose. So Northcote City will get the pickup. If I say Faulkner again, smack me right across the chops. I don't know why I'm thinking Faulkner.
That was a great ball in there, Blakey. Great header.
Wilford's grabbed it. Big Aaron, he's grabbed it, got it along there. We've got a man down at the moment. The goal scorers are sound down, having a bit of a breather. We'll come to that in a second. But Wilford, the referee's got the trainer on. Wilford's done, he's done fantastic round the back there. He's got a good challenging header in there. And basically, he'd be disappointed that she didn't go on the back of the net. And from that angle, actually, he's done quite well, actually, to hit that goal post. Because, mate, could have been a different story at 2-1 here at Amy Park. Looks like the boy's okay. Did you see what happened in there, Griff? Or was it just a bit of a breather, you think? Might be just going down for a breather. Because I have to admit, Dougie Hodson, when he was tired, he'd have a bit of a breather. In a couple of minutes, you just have a little breather, re-get your thoughts and ready to go again.
I think in your time, Dougie, they just told you to get up and put up and shut up. Now it's a bit different, but no, I didn't see what was off the ball, but it looks like he's getting up and he's going to be okay. But can we say Johnny A, very, very good substitute from him. But no, it looks like Ryan DeVries is coming off temporarily to get some treatment, and looks like he's in trouble, isn't he, Blakey?
He's in trouble. Yep, he's coming off there. There's a substitute there ready to come on, Stephen Hatzikotsis. Is the man, DeVries, who's been particularly damaging to start this, or in the second half, and has got the equalising goal. He's come off for treatment, so they're down to 10 men at this point. The Bentley Greens, it's locked at 1-1, and we've got around about 18 minutes of regulation left, so strap yourselves in. They want DeVries back on the paddock. He limps back on gingerly to hook up with the play. He's okay. He didn't look well, took a knock on the knee, but no change yet.
Yeah, I think Northcote probably would have liked to have seen DeVries get substituted off. Remember, he did score the two goals that got Bentley into the grand final. But Steve Hatzikostas looks like he's warming up on the sideline, so we possibly might see a change.
And it is that time of the game. Northcote City lose it through numbers. Cheeky from the big fellow, Milanovic. Blue shirts back. Awkward away. If he can away, he had nowhere to go, and finally crash tackled out of play was Hayden D'Agostino. And some issues on the bench, and there's going to be a yellow card issued to Luke Pilkington on the bench. He must have had a few words to say, Dougie.
It's going in McCormick's. It's all hands. You can see that on the replay there. They're all trying to fight and battle and get the ball away. It comes the referees here. Look, is it Pilkington, who was one of the gentlemen, whoever it was, he's thrown the ball back, and obviously the referee's fault. Well, that's probably unfair. Gentlemen, don't need to that say. McCormick's having a great game up there. Don't need to be involved, and he's bringing McCormick
on. And, yep, no, they've made the change. You're talking about McCormick. He's just been dragged, so Dougie Hodson, credibility zero at this point. Pilkington comes out and is replaced by Steve Hatzikotsis.
Who can play, may I say, Blake, he can play. Looking like Northcote's making a substitution as well. Coming that on there. Looks like coming off is Alex Rogers has came off in the centre of the park. Dean Piemonte looks like it's going on there for Northcote. Mate, I think McCormick's done a great job. He's a hustler and bustler. He's been getting in the final third. He's given him a good hard run at the times in there. Done well. Ball played long. Up again. Clean with a header. Webster kicked in the head. Dangerous play. Can't disagree with that. Big centre forward, brave as we can, brave as lions. Great, put his head where it doesn't hurt. Centre halves normally do, centre forwards don't, but that boy there did. He's up, he's okay, wasn't malicious, ball was there to be struck, and obviously big centre forward put his head there. We have a free kick, 20 yards out. We've got Dean Piemonte. This could be his first strike of the ball for Northcote City. Can he put the ball in the back of that onion bag? Let's see what he's got. We've got a five-man wall. Sitting in there, Webster lines up. Referee, they've asked for 10. Referee says 10, we've got to wait for his whistle to be taken. What we got, referee saying, gentlemen, there's your wall there. In line with your linesman, he's asking a question. Tell you what, I'd hope he wouldn't be bricklayer making a wall like that, Blakey, because the mortar would be going off, it'd be that bad, my friend. I think the referee's setting the wall up. Webster, have you got it lined up? Mate, you are. Who's going to take this? Looks like Newboy. He's got 10 yards. I think they're rowing about 2 inches. Let's see what it is. Lines up. Ball's there. Webster lined. Boys are in there for a runner. One touch, two strike, and that is
hit row. We'll go one go row. Zeb will sit in about row A or B. It wasn't too bad. We got a woo from the crowd. Webster wants the ball back. We're live. Deira, he's ran away. He's got it out wide, Kenny, and he's ran it out. He took his eye off the ball. Rule of thumb as a defender, you don't take your eye off the ball.
Just Webster there giving a ball to his back four. And again, Johnny A likes to play it from out the back and play on the ground. But, you know, it's a grand final. You're in the nervous moments. We're in the 76th minute. It's times like this. You don't want to be making any unforced errors.
Well, I've been nervous all day. It hasn't taken me this long to get wound up. A loose ball stray over the line. Calafatidis couldn't quite touch it. Dougie Hodgson very, very excited. I know it because he touches me. We're live streaming on the internet from Amy Park in Melbourne on a gorgeous day. You'd want a pina colada and a deck chair on a day like this, wouldn't you? And Tara Moss, as in no particular order, by the way.
To be fair, Blakey, Webb's disappointed with there. He's obviously hit it straight to Northcote. Northcote player, Webster. If you're going to go, Griff, you might as well go wide in areas, you know, straight to a Northcote player. If you're going to put yourself back under pressure, like Griff saying before, grand final, final third, strike through the ball. Can't score in the final third. We're underway. Back in. Wallace on the ball.
Wallace on the ball for the Bentley Greens. Half chance becomes a genuine chance. Top of the box. Ball peeling off the pack and finally hoiked away by Konstantinidis to midfield. Belted long by Jack Webster and it drifts away, away, away over the line. And it will be a turnover. It will come up Northcote City's way. We are locked at 1-1. We are in the grand final. We are 13 minutes from the end of regulation time in the big one for season 2013. Pierre Monti runs for it short. He elects to go long with the throw, glancing off the head to midfield. Knocked in the air by Milovanovic. Exchange of possession twice. Exchange of possession thrice. The new man on Hatzikosis goes wide. With the ball stumbling over the football was the Arbrew, the other substitute on. He'll get a second go at it. No, he won't. The referee, Lucien Lavadure, calls the free kick. Lucien Lavadure. It sounds like a 1920 actress, doesn't it? Presenting Lucien Lavadure. And it will be Northcote City. They took the lead. Just to recap, Northcote City taking the lead on 62 minutes through Evan Kunivalis, or an own goal, was it? That's the way we saw it. And the equaliser coming 5 minutes later through Ryan DeVries. And the goalkeeper takes it, goes short. So we're still locked at 1-1. A sense of drama and tension around this unfolding contest here at Amy's Stadium. The man at the top of the box is Lewis, laconically rolls it wide. Kunivalis, the danger man. Long shot across the face of goal by Christian Konstantinidis.
Should have done better there, Blake. Have a look at the replay. Takes a touch, looks in, pines his arm, midfielder. Oh, if it hit his body on his quad, that's in the back of the net in there. Great ball across. It's coming in there. Must get in there. You've got to get something on the end of that, and you must.
What about Milos Lewis? Just let that go by. Dougie, in your day, you know, that goal instinct, that striker instinct, that's why the top strikers get paid the big money. If he got on the end of it, that could have been another goal.
If it's on goal bonuses, I'll give you the tip. The boys in England would have said, I touched that. That's in the back of net. We're back in the play. In the play, Blakey. Ball's been played out wide.
Kunivalis again. He has been particularly hot in this second half. Kunivalis closed down by two. Weight of numbers. Bentley Green's come away with it. Toward midfield. Good ball on the outside. Got his shirt tugged, I reckon. Did Sherbon. Gets to the edge of the penalty area. Takes out the measurement. Should have been a better finish that from Hatzikosis, the man on. Maybe just dwelled over it a little too long. Had too long to think about it. Konstantinidis for Northcote City. We are locked at one each. We are 10 minutes away from the curtain coming down on regulation time in the grand final of 2013, young Grippo.
Just bearing in mind, Steve Hatzikotsis, he has come back from a broken leg that he suffered at Oakley Cannons. And here he is today. He's on a grand final and who knows, he could be involved in a winning team.
Right now, it is one each, Dougie.
Great, we've seen boys coming back from an injury, Griff and Blakey. You know,
the game can be very cruel with us at some times, and it's good the boys have come back to the Amy Park. It's fantastic here. But there's just giveaways. Bentley Green at the moment, for my liking, guys are giving the ball away. It's like it's a brochure around the line. Outside wide, what we got? Well done in there by Matthews. What's he got? 1-2. Touch of hand. We're playing on. Northcote's got the ball. Referee, can we have some advantage, please? Underway. What we got? Heads up, looking for a short ball. No, we're going to take it now. Referee says, back you come now, Bentley. Free kick, 45 yards, 40 yards out. He's having a look in here, having a look, see what the big boys have took there. There's the big planks, Kasparis. Away he goes, clipped in. Great ball in, that's a great dripping ball. And Webster, fantastic hands, looks wide, long, early. We break, Bentley Green's under the way we go. Jamie Dubois, boy on the thing. We've got the other end of there. De Vries on the far side, can we switch that ball? He's beat one, beat two, but as far as you're going to hit a brick wall, son, you're not going anywhere, says Northcote's. Great defensive there. Great work back to the keeper. Gets him under a bit of pressure. Left foot swings. Only as far as Wallace over his head. And James back in the big fella. One touch. Looks up. Little shimmy. Dances Weaver. Little 1-2. Ooh, little touch again. 1-2 again. Little triangles playing. And there's Sherbin. Will be disappointed of that pass out to the far side here at Amy Park. What we got? 81 minutes clicking into 82 minutes coming in, Blakey. Griff Masters. What are we going to see in this last 10?
Well, that's two letters, E.T. I don't refer to the movie in the 80s either, but it looks like it's bearing down to that time. We had the last 10 minutes with a bit of injury time. But Bentley, just attack's been breaking down on the right through Debrew. Here's Wallace now as he's got possession.
So Wallace, the skipper, and it's clear that Griffo's had his medication, so he's feeling pretty good about the world. Debrew spins out of trouble. Blue shirts back there plenty. Wallace recollects. Hatsikosis into the box. Top of the 6-yard area. Goalkeeper gets it easy in the end. Peter Monti was the man with the save. And this time Faulkner go forward. Frustration from Lewich. As the Bentley Greens go forward again. Hatsikosis goes outside for De Vries. Great cutback by De Vries from an angle. Chance still. Diabru cleared. Desperation stakes. Wow, it's getting frenetic again now. Gasparas for the runner. Cunavalis, who's been terrific in the second half. Ball into the area. Just too long for the runner. Bentley Greens will come up with it. Line of four, the man back, Matthews, Tom Matthews, and away they come again. We are now 4.5 minutes away from the end of regulation time in the grand final, Dougie.
Tell you what there, Blakey, referee said, up you go, son. You know, can't have a dive, I would have gave you an 8.5 for the dive on the Rectisale. And here we are, mate, and the game is starting to open up. A lot more room in the middle of the park. Boys are starting to get tired. Who's got the run of these legs in these last 9 minutes of this game? Here at Amy Park, can he take him on? He loves that little rollout. Overstep, can he? Yes. Can he find someone midfield? Yes, he can. Little donk in. Can he pick him out? Yes, he can! That is a great ball! You give that boy a little no goal, says the referee. I was going to give the man credit. He's had one sniff of the goal, and that is why he is the goal-scoring champion of the season. Referee's pulled it back in. It looks like it's a linesman's decision. We've got an offside there. Great football by Norkett. They'll be disappointed they haven't took that opportunity, but if it's offside, she's offside. Great ball chipped in. And was it offside, my friend? It's all, we've got the hands are shaking. Ange Poster, he'll be thinking the same thing about last night's game in the A-League.
Well, we're set up for a big finish. It started with a bang. It's going to end with a bang. And we have a last gasp winner in the grand final 2013, Amy Park, Greg Blake, Doug Hodgson, and young Griffin McMaster on deck to call the action through to the culmination of the 2013 season. We've had a missed penalty. We've had an offside goal. We've had two strikes, one to either side. And we are now set up as we enter the last 5 minutes of an engaging, engrossing, gripping contest. D'Agostino launches one into the front half. The running from Kalafatidis is not enough to see the ball stay in play, and Bentley Greens
will restart it from their own end through the goalkeeper, Stuart Webster, the skipper. And we've got a change.
Mr. Michael Catalano's coming on. Young boy that was had down at Richmond. I've seen this boy grow up. Has got some pace. Will shoot, will score. Let's see what the young man's got. Last six. James is coming up with a great round of applause from the Northcote supporters. As you can hear it, James can't have a seat. He's had the opportunities with working with James when he's grown up as well. And a great solid player. Looking like he's a little bit tired in there. Loza. Well done, Michael Catalano. What's he got in the bag for us, Griff?
Yeah, we're just also bearing in mind now, Northcote, they've had two substitutions and Bentley have had two, so they've both got one left. And as we creep inside the 87th minute, and just touching on that goal, that disallowed goal before, fantastic cross picked out by Gasparis there. He could have gone for a shot and been a little bit selfish, but he looked to the main target man, and Lewic, you know, he has been a bit quiet this game, but unfortunate, linesman got him offside.
So we've got one last twist in the tail in regulation. Chiapetta, the skipper of Northcote City, back for Wilford. Turns it away from danger. Got some assistance as well. Turn over the ball. Awkward. They're getting tired. It's getting a little bit scrappy. This guy's been sensational. Kunivalis, not that time. Konstantinidis, charged down, but it's going to be... a handball against the Bentley Greens player. Here come Northcote City again. Gasparis. Right foot, speculative. Finds the man. Kunivalis, the danger man. Dances inside the box. Kunivalis to the line. Can't drag it back. Can't get the corner. Can't make the best of an opportunity as we head into the last three. Heart pills time. Stay steady if you're there by the internet. Because this grand final is... on a nice edge. Webster waits. Haven't got a lot of time. Would they be, Dougie, you're aware of the time in a situation like this. What do you do?
Basically, they'll be saying, well, you've got, you know, 2.5 minutes. There'll be probably a couple of injury time as well. On the top of it, I think they'll be trying to kill the game and just finish it off to get to full time and then go into extra time. But, mate, as we know, that watch is going. There's still opportunities. We're in the final 30 at Bentley. Ball's being played, has his touch, fantastic ball skill. Love to see that here at the football, Amy Park Stadium. What's he got, one, can he beat? Yes, he can. Can he finish? Yes, he can! No, he can't! It's a great left-hand bottom save from the goalkeeper here as the replay comes on. Little cheeky, little turn, heads up, little flick, touch, opens his body up, bottom, left-hand, just past the pace. That was brilliant goalkeeper analysis, Griffmaster. What have we got?
Yeah, Chris Petropoulos, fantastic goalkeeping from him. His angles were very good. He set at the right moment. Ryan De Vries again. He's been magnificent this match, hasn't he, Dougie?
He's done quite well. I think both keepers have done quite well. They haven't had a lot to do, but what they've done very well. But, mate, we're into the last. What we're saying, Blakey, mate, do you know what's going on in the time clock? Yeah, you know it's coming soon. Final third. Ball's coming in from the far side.
Hatsikos is with the corner for the Bentley Greens. Got a bit of a swing on it and away in the end by Obradovic. And the ball goes out of play. Midway inside attacking territory for the Bentley Greens. We're locked up at 1-1. We're in the last minute of regulation time of the grand final of 2013. The big fella could not control it. Tried the back heel. Nothing doing. Northcote City on the break. If there's something there. No. Turned over again. The loping form of Aaron Wilford. Turnover possession again. Green shirts there. They'll get the chance, crash tackle, it's desperation stuff. The referee, Lavadura, is letting it go, and well done him. A leaping gazelle-like Daubru coughs up the ball. Northcote City on the move, the danger man, Kunivalis. Kunivalis turns inside onto his left foot. He's got the square ball. Launched for Lewic, glancing header, couldn't quite get to it. Goalkeeper Wilford. And away come the Bentley Greens. Got to keep an eye on that fourth official to find out just how long there is going to be in injury time in a deadlock grand final, one each. 5 minutes of time added on. As of now, we have ticked into time added on in the grand final. It's a heart stopper here at Amy Park on this glorious Melbourne afternoon. The grand final, the season decider comes down to this. All the pain. of the season, Koonavalas. Has he got men in support? No, the ball is too long. He ached and he drew breath and he stretched his hammies in an act of desperation, all to no avail.
Koonavalas, he's a young fella. I think he's, 19, 20 years of age. Dougie, I remember when you were 19, I think you could run all day to the hill, couldn't you?
He looked like he had a bit of lactic acid build up there. We're underway here though. DeVars, he's got a great touch. Oh, it's Farrell. Referee's called over. And the flagman at Tullamarine Airport lifts his flag and says, bring in the plane, the big 457, here in the last 4 minutes to go. Mate, he's done well, DeVars, a young kid. I tell you what, he'll be running out of legs because he has ran all day. He's looking weary, but he looks thin. He looks athletic. Them legs can run, I give you. He's holding his hand. Actually, he looks a bit like me now. He's bent over, hands in the back of his head, and that's the way we're normally breathing in these days. Last 4 minutes, grand final, straight, ball long. Up there goes to Webster, straight through to the other Webster. There we go again, hands up, we go wide. Webster's looking, yes it is, thrown out wide to D'Angelo. He's been a little bit quiet. I would love to see him a bit more into this game. He's got the ball head up. There's not much movement. Little cheeky one into the midfield. Third man coming out, he looks back into the other midfield, brings it across, little glance over his shoulder, looks around, see what he's got, movement, out wide again, looks back inside, well checked off, one touch turn, can he pull the trigger? Goes out wide again, just running out of the old lactic acid, just a little bit more composure in there, just a nice sweet spot, knock that ball down, but mate, they've been going 90 minutes, it's warm out there, because under this shade, Blakey and Griff, we're okay, we haven't even factored 30 today where we're sitting.
Yeah, but it's also important the older players like Milanovic and Wayne Wallace, you know, their leadership has to come through in this second, you know, well, if the game is likely to go into extra time. Young players, they're going to have to keep running. They've got no choice but to, as Koonavalas gets one down on the right-hand side back to Konstantinidis.
Konstantinidis drills one, finds a free man in traffic. The runner, Gasparas, goalkeeper comes. Well, the edge that these players had when they were fresh and early in the game appears to have been lost under, well, the arduous circumstances. They played the full 90 minutes. There's only about 90 seconds remaining. This kid's been sensational, Koonavalas, in the second half. Created the go-ahead goal for Faulkner. That's sweet stuff from Catalano. Catalano dances his way through traffic, releases the ball for Koonavalas, who was 5 metres away and still... dragging his hands on hips pretty much. Don't a bit critical. Might have been a free kick. Sherbon pulled it the other way. He's called it the other way. Sherbon went to ground. So did Hayden D'Agostino. Let's watch it again. Six of one, half a dozen of the other. Dougie, we are almost out of time. As Daryl Hall and John Oates once sung. Hall and Oates, great band. Where are they now? It's... There's going to be one last roll of the dice for Northcote City, I suspect. Back spinning 7-iron into the front half. Get the chance again. Great ball, Koonavalas. No. Great defence then from Jack Webster. And ouch, they are going at it right now. Some recriminations.
He might be only 19 years old, Griff, but he's got a little bit of go in him. He wasn't happy. Little words of wisdom between him and they look like Matthews there. But, guys, it's been brilliant. A little bit of the last 25 minutes has just been end-to-end. The game's opened up. There's some tired bodies out there, as we know, and I'm led to believe that this game is not going to golden goal. It's going to go 15 minutes each way and then into penalty. So golden goal, I'm led to believe, is a no-go. Webster strikes it long. Blue balls go up. Clash in there. And it goes... and goes... plays it 1-2, heads up. Blakey's having a little meltdown at the moment. We're okay. Great challenge in there by Angelo. Back in the midfield. He's got nothing on. Yes, he has. He's found him. Oh. Rages the defensive direction. Hey, he's done well, the defender there. What's he got? Little one touch. Can he get it on the ground? Can we play some football? Get it down. Little take. Heads up. Not much moving by my little 19-year-old. He's been sensational today too. Wallace intercepts. Matthews. Heads up. What's he got in there? Turns. Oh, he's giving a square ball away. This could be. Could it be? Catalano. Rolls. Turns. Guys, they're giving the ball away. That fatigue stepped in there at the present moment in time. There's some tired legs. The referee's going to blow any minute. Any second. We're waiting on the whistle. Is this the last chance? He holds. 10. No, play on, says the referee. And there goes the whistle, Mr. Greg Blake. The final of 90 minutes.
Well, I don't know about you, Dougie and Griffo. I haven't got a lot left in the tank. It's been, look, let's just have a quick look. Now, we're going to two periods of 15 minutes for the grand final. So you thought it was over, but now they've got to do it all again, and they will be tired, boys. It's very warm out there, around about 25 degrees here at Amy Stadium. Just quickly as a recap on that second half, it was scoreless at halftime. At second half, the go-ahead goal, Evan, crediting it to Evan Kunivalis on 62, and then of course the equaliser from Ryan DeFries on 67. We've had a missed pen, we've had a couple of goals that were scored that were ruled offside, so the grand final's had everything, but now it becomes, I suspect, on the basis of the last 5 or 10 minutes, it's going to be a war of attritions. Attrition. Mistakes will be made, they will be tired, boys. I suspect this, if you thought the first half of this grand final was something to savour, something to grab out of a salve bottle and rub all over yourself, you wait till you see extra time. This is going to be an absolute beauty. I'm looking forward to it, Dougie Hodgson and Griffin McMaster, to wrap up what we've seen thus far.
Yeah, well, though, Blakey, it has been a sensational one, the last 25 of that day. It's all been football from end to end. We love it, mate. FFV brought us into this today, Blakey. Well done, FFV, for streamlining this into the internet. It's been a fantastic day all around for the VPL 2013 Grand Final. We're sitting here at 1-1 in this Grand Final. 2 15-minute blocks. I've got Johnny with me and Griffo. We're going to talk about you two, about this game so far. The game's opened up, tired legs. Is Bentley Green, and we discussed on it lightly before, is Bentley Green's going to have the upper legs here, as we call it, because of the weak break that they've had?
Dougie, what a sensational 90 minutes. I mean, we saw in the first half, Bentley come out and had an early chance on goal, had a penalty, had a goal disallowed. We saw Northcote trying to get back into it, got into it towards the end of the first half. Second half, pretty much the same pattern as the first, although Northcote had a couple of really good opportunities within the first 10 or 15 minutes of that second 45 minutes. And then of course Evan Kunivalis, who really came into the play on that right hand side for the Northcote City side, ended up scoring the first goal via a deflection, so rather fortuitous. But then of course Johnny A made the substitution for Bentley Greens and brought on young Jamie Dabrew, and took off of course David Sturton, and that changed things around. Of course, Bentley were able to fashion an equaliser within 3 or 4 minutes, and then it just became end-to-end stuff. We had chances at both ends, we had opportunities, half chances. We saw Chris Petropoulos in the Northcote goal pull off a wonderful save in the last few minutes. But Griffo, what can you say? I mean, if that 90 minutes was something to go by, the extra time's just going to be sensational.
Yeah, there really hasn't been a split pea between the two sides. And, well, the first half, we all agree that Bentley were they were the better side in the first period. Second half, Lozanowski's obviously rallied his troops on and changed things around, and they come out and had two early opportunities, and they got the opening goal through Kunivalis, and he's been fantastic today. Bentley got back into the match through Ryan DeVries, and of course Ryan, he's been, you know, those two players have probably been the best players on the park, ironically, the two goal scorers. But Northcote, they've had chances in the second half. They made a couple of substitutions. Their midfield has been a lot better than it was in the first half. Piemonte's definitely given them a bit of go for, which is what they need. Gasparis has been fantastic, and of course he set up a goal to Lewich, but of course it was given offside and wasn't allowed. But Northcote, definitely a lot better in the second half, but really it is a 50-50 toss of the coin. You just can't tell who's going to go be the victor.
Griffo, absolutely true. I mean, for the neutrals amongst us, it's just been an absolute spectacular display here at Amy Park. Of course, you're tuning in on the locker room and via Facebook and on the YouTube to the locker room special coverage of the VPL 2013 Grand Final here at the VPL between the Northcote City side and, of course, Bentley Greens. Pardon me, ladies and gentlemen. And it's locked at 1-1 here at full-time. We're going into extra time, and as Griffo said, it could go either way.
Yeah, no, it's an enticing encounter as Lucien Lavaduri does the coin toss for the first time or so should I say, for the first half of extra time. And it looks like that Northcote won the toss and they're going to run on the screen from right to left as they get into a huddle. And the Bentley players just gathering their thoughts as John Anastasiadis has had a good chat to his side. And bearing in mind also both teams have one substitute left each. And, well, we talked about it before with Doug Hodgson earlier about the week off that Bentley had. Is that going to play in the second half? And as Dougie rejoins us back into the studio, Dougie, what's any more thoughts? You know, as I said, extra time. Now, is it really going to make a difference coming into, you know, 120 minutes of football?
I have to admit though, Griff, thanks Joe Pod. Mate, Kunavaris, he's been outstanding for me today. He's done a great job out in the wing. The boy's tired. And if you think back, Erevans came out on the right-hand side, which has been great. Can they adapt and get a little bit more out in the left? Because that boy's tired. He's a young boy, we know that. Hopefully he's got a bit more in the bank. Catalano obviously in the left-hand, will go out in the left-hand side, no doubt. Or has he gone in alongside in the middle, which it looks like he's gone in the middle. So, mate, Griff, Masters, we have got 2 15-minute halves of this grand final 2013. Will Bentley Green have the legs? I think they might find the legs in this week off that they've had. Welcome back, Mr. Black.
I got lost. I got lost at Amy Stadium. And now at Amy Park. And now I want to get lost in the final 30 minutes of the season. Or will it be? Do we go to penalties? Who knows? It's one each in the grand final. Live streaming on the internet on a gorgeous afternoon. If you have any sense, you'll take your laptop out of the backyard and lap up this gorgeous weather and enjoy the last 30 minutes of the Victorian Premier League season. Northcote City 1 went ahead on 62. Bentley Greens 1 equalised on 67. And now the pressure of two periods of 15 minutes either way, extra time, is upon us as we scan for changes for this extra time period. That was a cheap turnover. Wayne Wallace goes straight up the middle. The runner off the ball was Dabru. Dabru gets his arm tugged at. Should have been a free kick. Wasn't. Weaves his way into the box. Good running back by Obradovic. Did well to keep the ball in bounds. And away come Northcote City. Long bouncing. One hop. Two hops into Bentley Green's territory. Loping back after it. The big fella Aaron Wilford. Back to his goalkeeper. They'll start again as the first minute of extra time. The pressure compounds, doesn't it, when you get down to this situation. It's life or death. The whole season rides on this one. D'Angelo Dominic launches himself towards the defenders, and he has brought down, I reckon, there wasn't a lot in that, but Chiappetta, the skipper, unbalances the runner. Dominic D'Angelo, it will be a free kick to the Bentley Greens, spotted about 2 metres outside the penalty area. Slightest of angles.
Tell you what there, Blake. He was unlucky there, mate. He's actually touched, let him down. Actually got his second touch, went out there, outside, and the skippers came in and just caught him on an awkward as he's flying through. But here we are. Milanovic on the ball. Wilford makes his way up. 18-yard box. Everyone from Northcote's back. A helicopter could land here on the left-hand side. It's Amy Park. We're on the ball. Chipped in. First man. It's donked in there. We have, man, we have a goal. Yes, we do. We have number 20, Bentley Greens. Luke Sherman, the man that's won Media Player of the Year for Bentley Greens, has took Bentley Greens 2-1 into this 2013 Grand Final as the hugs and kisses go on in front of us here today. This is now going to be an interesting game. Webster's ran out of his goals. One arm in the air. He's a very happy boy, as you would be. Mate, this is going to bring on a different capacity of the game now, buddy. 20, talk to me, Blakey. Griff, 25 to go.
Well, a gripping encounter, and I tell you what, the Bentley Green fans, we haven't heard much from them today, but they are becoming a little bit animated. They've come from behind. In this grand final, we've played 2 minutes 50 of extra time in the grand final, and Bentley Greens have taken that long to strike, and it must it behooves me to say that the Bentley Greens probably deserve the lead on the balance of play over the day, but they've had to do all the hard work to get there. Are the floodgates open, or have Northcote City got something? D'Arbru. D'Arbru brilliant into the box, had his back to the goal, and a turn shot on the turn, boom, into the terracing here at this magnificent stadium.
Diabru, again, that's his strength. He's got pace down the right, and he took on the left back very well. And a good opportunity in the box, and Northcote, they're chasing the game now.
So Northcote City now with the work to do. And again, that man, Grease Lightning. Diabru. Ball reef loosed by the skipper, Chiappetta. The skipper, long ball, way too long. Back for the goalkeeper. He'll allow it to run. Under not very much pressure. Bentley Greens lead it by 2-1. Grand final 2013. It is Amy Park on this glorious Saturday afternoon. And this team in green, coached by John Anastasiadis, have got the lead. There's still a long, long journey in this game now to go. Sorry, Dougie.
It's all right. As you said, ball being played in the Sherbourne. There is a long way to go there, Blakey. Mate, great game so far. It's livened up. What are we going to bring on, Griff? We've got what substitution do we got down there, Griff? What's the both sides got on there, mate?
Really, Luke Pilkington is probably one player they can aim to bring on. And that looks about it on the Bentley side. And with the Northcote side, well, no one's warming up as such. So looks like there won't be any changes coming anytime soon as Webster picks one up out to DeVries out on the left.
DeVries runs one tackle, spears it, but turnover. Obradovic, he turns it over, and Kindai are tired boys out there. Is this man again, Diabru? Diabru's going to run at the defender. He can just about bet on it. The defender did well, the skipper. Piedamonti came on in the second half of regulation time and was busy early. I'll draw the free kick. The man going to ground with a smile on his face was Dane Milovanovic. And it will be a free kick to the Bentley Greens, who've had the edge in play for most of the afternoon. They've had the edge in the scoreline for just the last 3 minutes. They've had to work back from a one-goal deficit. They are now 2-1 in front in the decider. We've played 6 minutes of the first 15 of extra time. Bouncing through a triangle of blue shirts, the big fellow Milovanovic again, and he's becoming particularly familiar with the turf of Amy Park in the last couple of minutes, just enjoying a little roll around on the grass. We all do, Dougie. Don't be ashamed. Milovanovic with the free kick from half field. Loses meterage, finds a teammate, Jack Webster. Webster pokes it up the line. Bentley Greens come again. Has their floodgates open. They're looking pretty sharp at this point of the game. Cross, not quite cleared. Hatsikosis, lose out. Catalano, big steal. Then by Wallace, we'll get another look at it, Wallace. And the flag has gone up. So Wayne Wallace hasn't been his greatest afternoon, but he'll be pretty pleased at the moment because Bentley Greens, the team he captains, so marvellously well, so resolutely, if you will, is leading by 2-1. Griffo.
Well, it's been pretty much one-way traffic in this extra time, hasn't it? Bentley have had a lot of better play. Northcote, just look, they just don't look energetic at the moment. They're going to have to lift the gear, haven't they, DH?
Looking there, though, Griff, I have to admit, though, mate, they're very static. You know, you could hear the skipper, you could hear words from up here. The skipper's given some information out to his teammates, and now it was revving. Ball's played into a dangerous area. Aaron Wilford picks up, looks, vision, played into Shoebourne, plays a one out wide. Has he got the legs? Yes, he has. Have we played on? Yes, it is. Has he kept it in? Yes, there's a little elbow. That's a bit naughty, may I say. That was the referee. Linesman, you're both looking at it. We can see him from here. And he's bleeding. How's he looking? That's not a very good one. We're still on the play. Sherman's got the ball. Heads up. Picks it out. What we got? There's three Northcote players on the line. We're too busy watching out here, may I say, before. Cheeky elbow looking right in front of us. No need to do that, skipper. No need to do that, my friend. Don't be getting the game into malicious. Look at his state of his knee. That's copped him on the nose. Referee, we have a blood rule going on. You can hear the crowd, guys. We're going in here.
Well, it's becoming a little bit boom crash opera, but that's the way grand finals are played, I suspect. And he's brought a life there, this skipper, I suspect, Adrian Chiappetta. As There's a lull in play. We've got the player off the ground because it stopped gesticulating. Dougie, I have no idea what you're doing. And it's going to be restarted. Northcote City, they're down by 2-1. We're in the first period of extra time in the grand final of 2013. Still a man off the paddock, so they're playing a man short at the moment, Bentley Green. So do they get the sub on, did they?
Haven't missed yet, Blakey.
They are down to 10 men. Northcote City with the man advantage. Obradovic, the drag and roll, doesn't draw the defender. Lewic goes to ground. Meek effort then by Lewic. And away by Milovanovic. Goes coast to coast with that one and takes an aimless bounce out of play. They are tired. It's becoming a lot less structured and we've got the change now. Finally, Luke Pilkington on. Now, bear in mind that Luke Pilkington was yellow carded off the bench before as well. He's going to replace Jamie Diabru, who was the boy that was hit with, we don't know it was an elbow. We suspect it was some sort of, we're not going to make those wild, scurrilous accusations.
Yeah, I've got to say, it's probably a little bit silly from the referee. Lavadero, he's had a pretty good game, to be fair. He's done well. He's kept the tempers down for both teams, but I probably would like to have seen a free kick there. It was a bit of an act, towards D'Arbru. And now it's forced a substitution. Luke Pilkington has just come on now for Bentley Greens as they have just won a free kick in the middle of the park.
9 minutes, nearly 10 minutes away as Jamie Diabru gets the applause as he sits down on the bench with what's left of his face after that challenge. It's okay, a bit of ice on his nose and a full facial as the Bentley Greens up by 2-1. No flag, there's claim for offside. Push past, off the outside of the boot. The crowd went up, had psychosis, but he didn't get the angle on it, didn't even look close.
Well there, Blakey, played the ball back, find his midfield again. He's picked it up, a great block challenge. That's desperate defending there from the centre-half. He's put his body on the line, and that's what it's all about at this grand final level. As you can see here, mate, Bentley Greens are in no rush to get this corner there, Blakey.
They are up by 2-1, but we've still got something along the lines of about 20 minutes remaining. Two periods of extra time as Steve Hatzikosis goes back to take the corner for the Bentley Greens. They're up by 2-1, near post, stroked away. More by good luck and good fortune. Kunivalis, he's been terrific in this game in the second half, particularly the young fellow. Kunivalis backs himself to beat one challenger, can't beat two. The man getting his body in the way was the new man on Luke Pilkington. And oh dear, he is gone. He is in trouble. Had to be.
That is silly, my friend. That is absolutely silly. No need for it, mate. He's obviously, he's got caught up in the moment, but, mate, retaliation, what's the go? Here we go. That's not what we really need to see at a grand final, gentlemen. Hey, not that we nearly need to see, With players out there at the moment, there's heated, there's 2-1. Obviously, the boys are feeling a bit emotional at the moment in this game. Physicality, it's been up and back, and obviously the passion's obviously taken over to it as well. But it looks like Luke Pilkinson's going to be removed from the game from Bentley Greens.
Yeah, we'll have to double check that, but he did get the red card.
Yes, he did.
He did. Absolutely. Yeah. Luke Pilkington has played about 6 seconds of football.
It's quicker than Danny Tiardo.
He has been on for just a couple of moments, Luke Pilkington, and now through an act of impetuousness at best, he's leaving the field of play in disgrace. The red card, I'm sure he was the player booked on the bench earlier on in the game. So whether it's a double yellow or a straight red, it doesn't matter. The result is the Bentley Greens, who are 20 minutes away from winning the Victorian Championship for the first time, are now reduced to 10 players, with Luke Pilkington coming off the paddock. And I beg to differ a little bit, Dougie. You're saying you don't want to see this. On the contrary, I want to see this, because that tells me you've got two sides there ready to duke it out for the last 20 minutes of the biggest game of the season. So you've got two sides ready to get chest and face in to another chest and face. So that's chest and face all together. And say, baby, I'm not going down without a fight.
Is that face and chest or chest and face? Face and chest. But you're right, Blakey. It is passion. It is what we want out there. But obviously not malicious. And we don't want to see players injured or hurt. Anyway, that will go down in the record book. 6 minutes, if we're lucky. Well, 6 seconds. Back to the game, though. Let's get the ball going. Aaron Wilford gets it back down. Pays it out to the skipper. Been involved in a few great ball out there. Wide out to Obradovic.
takes him on. Can he? Yes, he does. Find a yard. Picked across and we have a goal! Picked off Aaron Wilford. He'll be disappointed about his defensive. He's going to get a yellow card now. The referee still got it. Ready out in his hands. Over the fence to the supporters here at Omi Park. Off goes the shirt and as he comes on, I've got no doubt the referee will be giving him a yellow card.
And I tell you what, for Lewich, who is currently topless and looking fantastic, by the way, Lewich, who has had a really, really poor game, a quiet game, I should say, for the top scorer in the competition. He has now left an indelible mark on the grand final. Tighten your seatbelts, folks. It's 2-2 in the season decider, Griffo. And the big fellow Lewich has scored the equaliser. It is all happening at Omi Park on this glorious spring afternoon.
Well, Dougie just touched on before, Lewich, very quiet game, but Luke Pilkington, I'm sure he'd be sitting in the dressing room right now and he'd be having his head down his hands and looking at his discipline, not too good. Lewich, his discipline wasn't great, he took his shirt off, he's just got a yellow card, but he's on the park still. It's game on and it's 2-2.
Interesting to go there, Griff, because I tell you what, mate, this game for Bentley Greens, as you know, you go down 10 men, normally fire, they end up with more fire in the belly because they've got a lot of work harder. That can also go the other way. Tired legs, though. We're into this first half, this extra time. And we've got in. Ball's been played in. Great defending in there. Looks like by the captain with Wallace in there. But, mate, I have to admit, though, this game is getting very exciting now, Blakey. Very exciting, Griffo.
It's becoming a little bit ugly and a little bit fractured, but a little bit... Interesting to call because you just don't know where it's going to go. Does he take a shot from a distance? Goes long. And Lewich, who is going into the scorekeeper's book. We've played 15 minutes. We've played the first 15 minutes. The Northcote City supporters, they're pretty darn happy right now, as they should be. We've had a couple of lead changes. We've had a send-off. We've had a missed penalty. We've had... a couple of injuries. It's you know, you can't, I know it sounds a little cliched, but in a 2-2 drawn grand final with now 15 to play in the second period of extra time, you can say this one's pretty much had it all.
I reckon we've got value for your buck today then, Blakey, for these punches and through these turnstiles on the VPL. We're underway again, though. Mate, told you before with Malini, he had one little sniff, and he's just scored that. It's a great goal. He's had two sniff, two goals, one... was basically disallowed. Ball's been sprayed wide. A bit of wind. Great first touch. Out there it goes. Castanis looks out. Can he get across? And yes, he can. He looked for someone. Catalano. One touch. Side foot. Kazoo. He'd be very disappointed there. Miedo could have answered. He's had a great game. So that would have finished his day off today, Blakey.
As the referee, Lucien Lavadua, who has done a pretty good job under the circumstances. It's been a taxing game for players. It's been a taxing game for the officials. And this taxing game, this gripping struggle, this grand final, this day of decision, this day which makes a champion, the day they will remember when they look back and they're sitting on their rocking chairs and talking to their grandchildren. I was there. I played the day that we won the Premier League. It is 2-2. We've got 15 to play. We're on this live streaming on the internet from this magnificent venue. And you could not ask for more than this, Griffo. It's happening. It's a pandemonium. It's an epic theatre. It's a movie, magnificent James Cameron epic.
It certainly is, Blakey. Fantastic game we've had today. We've had absolutely everything. And we've still got another 15 minutes to bring ahead of us. And what is going to be, all we can say is going to be another probably exciting 15 minutes that's ahead of us. Bentley Greens down to 10 men. They're up 2-1. They ordered a bus from the bus company to try and park it in front of the goals, but it was too late. Milos got on the end of a cross from Obradovic, it was. And now it's game on. You've got to think now, Northcote, well, I think Bentley, they'll be playing for penalties quite simple. I think Northcote, it's their game for the taking. I think they've got to attack this half, but they've also got to be mindful that they can't let one in as well.
So the sands of time are running through the hourglass on what has been an epic grand final encounter. Just a quick run through. Evan Kounivalis gets the go-ahead goal. for Northcote City on 62. Ryan DeVries levels it for the Bentley Greens on 67. We are into extra time. And another go-ahead goal, this time from somebody else. I've lost it.
We're just picking Greg Blake off the ground at the moment. He has seemingly lost the plot. We've got him back. He'll be getting the oxygen level in a minute. He'll be back soon. It's okay. Blakey, he's on the 98th minute, Blakey. We need you to keep going. Oxygen for Blakey, please, Griffo. The legend of the game is back. And don't you forget it. He is back. We're underway here. 15 minutes to play. Bentley Greens with the ball. Wallace knocks it in. Skipper has a look. Ball's being played in. You can see the tired legs. They're just having a bit of a strundle out there, Griffo and Blakey. A strundle, just a bit of a strundle, which is like a walk in the park.
You have unequivocally and yet in a most gorgeous manner butchered the English language this afternoon, Doug. And I'm sure your friends and supporters will be very, very proud of you, because the great irony is it is, Doug, you talk complete rubbish in a language that nobody understands, and yet we all completely understand where you're coming from. We're in the grand final. We've got around about 14 minutes remaining. It is locked at 2 each. And the Bentley Greens are down to 10 men with that bizarre send-off of Liam McCormack, was it? It was Luke Pilkington, I'm sorry. Late in that second half. Gee, it's been a long day and lots have happened. The striding, here he goes. The goal scorer, Kunivalis. Kunivalis can't get the angle. Great run back. Tom Matthews to stay with him, because the boy's got a little bit of leg about him. But it will be a corner to Northcote City, who've had to come from behind once today. Both sides have. Gasperis to take the corner for Northcote City. The fans have been loud and proud all afternoon. Gasperis is a floater. Goalkeeper can't make it. No one else can make it. Get the second chance. Double roll of the dice. No, they don't. And a double deck of cards. And a double dip at the ice cream machine. No idea where I'm going. Dougie. Great. It's a heart stopper.
It's a great ball in there, Blake. You just needed someone on the other end of it to pull that. Hey, 3-2. We got tied legs. 10 men to Bentley Greens. If you just joined us, Northcote playing what we got. Referee says it's a corner. Final third. Northcote on the ball. What can we bring today to Amy Park? Just a quick hello to me mate Blazer out there. He's in home recovering from hospital. Hope you were getting all right now, Pedro. Looking after yourself. Referee's having a word, hands down. Two boys at the back. He's giving it the old hand signal to the referee. They want to have a cuddle, tell them they're going to have a cuddle after. Ball played in, whipped in, missed the first man. Yes, it did. Keeper in, goal. OG, is it a goal or is it an OG? We can, we'll have to go back in. It's basically gone in. Looks like, I can't say who's going to claim it at the moment. Here it comes in, he's going to claim it, or did Aaron Wolfe hit the second? No one's marked again. He's got round the back. We said, give that boy a chance. He will score a great goal. That is Northcote. 3-2 up here in the VPL 2013 Grey Final at Amy Park. What a great, boys. There's an opportunity. They've got 10 men. Bentley Greens, you're going to have to chase again. What have they got in the bag here, Griffo?
They're saying, we'll go with you in a minute, that I reckon they're going to claim that it was Lewicz again, Milos Lewicz. We said he had a quiet game. He had 20 goals coming into this match for the grand final, and now he's got two, the equaliser and now the go-ahead goal. Goodness gracious me. Northcote ahead. Bentley Greens ahead. Northcote City ahead. That's the way it's gone this afternoon. It's like watching our Waverley Star and Bone Crusher at Flemington. And they are calling it for Milos Lewicz. Now Bentley Greens down to 10 men with it all to do. We have got 12 minutes to play in the grand final. And Northcote City supporters have been loud and they're just getting louder. And for Bentley Greens, again, it comes back to what a day of mishaps, miscues, missed penalties and players off the park. So it's been a challenge and free kick will go the way of Northcote City. Lucien Lavadua coming over to yellow card. Didn't see what for. Perhaps too much talking, Grivo. Where are you going with that?
Yeah, just another foul there. Northcote win, and I'm sure they would like to time waste at this present moment. Gasparis was the delivery of the cross, and Lewicz, just remember that Gasparis delivered one to Lewicz earlier, was given offside, but deja vu's happened, and this time the goal's been given. I've got to say now, it's Northcote's game to lose now. They're really in the box seat at the present moment.
Yeah, I'm a big subscriber to the fact if you head on the scoreboard, it is your game to lose. But thank you, Captain Obvious. Stroke of genius from young Griffo. We're all getting fairly tired up here. I wouldn't want to be out on the paddock. It's been a testing day. Lewich, two-goal hero. Is he going to be? Here they come. Gasparis runs. Gingerly they are tired, aren't they?
He's not moving there, Blakey.
Kurtavelis, the man that turned the match, perhaps. Konstantinidis. And again, Konstantinidis. Hold the football. String the passes together. Eat up the clock. Lofted pass not long enough for his teammate. Turned away upfield by Matthews. Bouncing ball for the skipper. Did well. Wallace. Pressure comes from D'Angelo. Is there a chance? DeVries ball over the top. Goalkeeper comes 2-3 metres out of his penalty area and just pummels it away to safety. That's all you need at this point. Do the job. Do what you need to do, Jack Webster. Jack Webster holds the ball aloft. Gets the throw. It's a bouncer for Wallace again. Loses it too easily. War of attrition. They're tired out there now. Stumbling over the football was Catalano. Regains his composure. He's got the man back. Takes the option. Long ball. Knocked away by the big fellow Aaron Wilford. Came off the Faulkner, the Altona, the Northcote, there's no, the Northcote City player. Here's a chance for the Bentley Greens.
Coming in, great challenge in there. We play on Mr. Luke, he's got Luke, he's got to miss the first man out, cleaned up there on the centre half. It's still ball in play, linesman flags, Bentley Green. Looks like a substitution's going to happen in front of us here at the moment. Looks like who's coming off, can we see Northcote bringing off 17. Or five, what we got, who's coming on now? I'm tipping Masparis is coming off. It's looking like Goran Lozanowski's going to lock shop. Griffo, boys, it's the board that's going on at the moment. We've got him in there. Can't see numbers.
Masparis has been absolutely fantastic this game. And, well, it's fitting. He's been fantastic all game. Now, coming on, the centre midfield. Coming on, the five, which we're just trying to get the numbers as we speak. Nick Soulis is going to make his way on. But as to Gasparis, he's been one of the better players. I wouldn't be surprised if he won man of the match today.
So he swapped midfield for midfield as we got Griffo. The lights, green light is, fresh set of legs. 10 minutes, 9 minutes, 8 minutes. 22 gone of the 30. Long throw. Hits it in. Great throw. Wallace bounce. No one's in there. Handballs. Goalkeeper. Goalkeeper gets a fist to it. Done extremely well in there in these tight situation. Rule of thumb for a defender, never let a ball bounce. They've got it early. Played down. Offside. Yes, he has. Linesman. Flags up. Got to be able to play it and move in there as soon as you can. Northcote, no worries about getting onto this game, Blakey. They're just taking the time. Just relaxing, trying to kill the clock. Bentley Greens. Got to go to them. I think Pilkington's probably going to have a lot to answer for because they're in a driving seat there at one stage and gone. Lozanowski's making sure that he's getting his team and he's structured right as he gives information.
Yep, yellow card indeed. It was time wasting. And it'll be the goalkeeper that will get the yellow card, Chris Petropoulos. Good game from him today. It's a yellow card with just on 7 minutes remaining and extra time in the grand final. It's locked at Northcote City 3, Bentley Greens 2 in the 2013 decider.
He's going to get another one by the looks of there. The referee sees this and he goes to his line. And this goalkeeper could be off in a minute. You've got a ball out there. There's a ball off the park. Goalkeeper's just turned around and threw it back into the game. You know, the referee's got out of jail there, trying to waste more time, which is a bit of stupidity there, Blakey, because he could have been in there with Pilkington's.
Well, this has been like Ryan Reynolds in the Greenland and had a plot twist that had no right to be in there.
He took the linesman's flag there as well. The centre forward's hoping that he would just take the ball and the flag. Ball's back in there. Matthews looks up for midfield. Cut out by the Kolaris. Oh, he's forgot that ball. He's had a good game. A little push. Little handbags at four paces there. Angelino on the right-hand side. They've got to get the ball going, Thomas. Out wide. Into the goal. Don't forget that ball there, Wilford. There it goes. Out of your feet. Up there into Milanovic. Plays it. What's he got on? Movement we need. 8-7-6 minutes to go. What's he got? He's looking. Wallace, skipper, plays it into space. Matthews, one on one.
He ain't, it's static, it's dead. Guys, we need something. Good little flick all the way to Northcote. He said, let's just clear it, and we'll get our little bit of positional play back into Webster's hands. Grab our shape. Skipper holding his line very well on the just inside the final D. Wilfred looking up long. Clips the ball into the final third. That's got snow on it. Back in there. That's for the skipper. He's had a great game, Agent Chan. He's done well. Catalano plays it in wide. They're not in no hurry. One touch, two, three, head up. He's on. Catalano's in over the top. No, hits his feet and he's in. Skipper, he's away. Brilliant play at the moment. Played out wide. Broken down again. Can't be on. Wallace. Game's going end to end. This is what it is. The last 5 minutes of play. All studs up. Clipped out there. Back into play. Back under the same far as Alan Wilford. It's getting a little bit tidy out there, boys.
It's just important, Northcote. They don't do anything silly. You know, they obviously the obvious time-wasting tactics, but just keep the ball. And there's another 4.5 minutes of time. If they get the ball, they just got to make the most of it. And, of course, they got to park the bus.
So it comes down to this. 4.5 minutes remaining in the 2013 grand final, knee in the 2013 season, and Northcote City are just that period of time away from winning the Victorian Championship for the first time. They lead by 3-2, all the goals coming after half-time in regulation, and a double from Lewicz, Milos Lewicz, has given Northcote City the lead in the depths of the grand final here at Amy Park here in Melbourne. Free kick.
Mate, what they got in here, Chan, now you're saying before, Griffo, there's no need to throw anything away at the moment. I think a few people have done it already. It's going to hurt some of them players playing with 10 men, 3-2 here in the Amy Park. They're going to go and play it short, waste time again. They've got opportunities here. That was a little flick over. He's turned him inside out. He'll have a referee. Yes, it is. That was a free kick. Matthews, he's done it. What have we got in here then, Griffo Blakey? Are they going to whip this ball in or is he going to play it into that corner? If I was the captain there, coach, we are looking at 3.5. I'd be wasting the time.
Lewicz there just using a bit of street smartness, winning the foul, running the clock down another 30 or 40 seconds, possibly more. It's just what Northcote need at the moment.
So let's ride this wave to the beach now. We're in seeing distance of the end of this epic grand final. It's turned out to be an epic. It started in grand fashion and it's ending in grand fashion as well. And perhaps the high point of the history of Northcote City. Or is there another kick in the tail? Is there another sting in what has been a remarkable grand final? Northcote City. Well won by Hatzikosis. Goes for the big man. Milovanovic, the ball outside. The runner, DeFries, powers at the football. Cleared, though, in the end by Konstantinidis. So, again, we look at the hourglass, and we've got 2:20 remaining in this extra time period.
I reckon there's going to be some extra time in there, too, Blake, of a few more minutes. I reckon we've probably still got 5 minutes to play in this VPL, brought to you by the FFV 2013 Grand Final at Amy Park. As we said earlier, they're just wasting time. What's that Big Ben as he stopwatches? It just keeps clicking down, and as far as Matthews in the play, helped on. Great diving header, finds it out wide. And as far as Obrenovic, plays it out wide again, keeps the ball. Piemonte. Heads up, he's not going to clip it in, haven't even the big fellas at the back. He's going to go to that corner. He's going to give himself a cup of tea and a Mars bar and just play it back and keep the ball. No time to waste. Switches play. And you've had a look at Bentley Greens. The three boys just waiting up. They're going to have one touch if Bentley Greens hit this turnover and they're going to knock it long. 3-3 at the back here. Making sure, keeping their shape. What's he going to hold and hold and hold? Three players. We've gone back to 4-3. Here it comes. Played out, and as far though, and as far as we've got it, into the midfield, keeps the ball, and we'll have a throw in, says Northcote Greeno.
Smart play from Northcote, just running the clock down, keeping the ball, numerical advantage. That's all they really need to do from now on in.
So the final setup as we tick into the 30th minute of extra time. It's Northcote City leading the Bentley Greens by 3-2 and just trying to milk the clock and get through for their first championship for both clubs. The first opportunity to win a Victorian Grand Final. We'll have to start thinking about the Jimmy Rooney medalist as well. There's a number of players out there who've had big games. Northcote City in possession again. The match changer, Kudavelis. He'll get a return ball. Wow, ouch, and bang.
Welcome to the game. He's got cramp down there, Blake. You'll be happy with that, Charlie. There you go.
Well, it's on again. I'll tell you, it is getting heated and hardly surprising. The pot is boiling. Wow, what stupidity then. Now it's just getting a little bit silly. The one thing it tells me, though, is that the Bentley Greens have not conceded yet. They have not conceded yet. We've got players up off the bench. And the referee, with a laconic look about him, Luciano Lavaggiore, comes over to try and add some sense to what could have ended in nonsense.
He's got to have a word to him there. He is obviously the referee. He's done quite well there, defuse the situation. But then, guys, there's no need for that. You've got a game, okay, be disappointed, but that's sportsmanship, guys. One thing I do, nothing wrong with the challenge. Great challenge in there. He's took the player, the ball, the whole shebang. So, free kick, Northcote, they're going to the corner.
Final word, Dougie.
My final word, mate, we have 1 minute. We're finished. It's been a great game. Supporters have paid their money. They've got every value for the buck. Brought to you by the FFV.
And he's going to get a final word from Griffo, but we're not going to get time for that as Northcote City looking to shore up the championship. Ball out of play and it's on again. Push and shove. We've got some angry boys out there. And quickly, Griffo, well, we've got just a moment in time. We're looking at the watch. We're into stoppage time in extra time.
Yeah, right. Northcote president Peter Katsiris, a.k.a. Mr. Football, making his way down. It's a big proud moment for him coming down.
So we are about to draw the curtain on the season. We are unsure. I'd reckon there'd be maybe 2 minutes. Maybe 2 minutes, Dougie. And it's still very heated. The entire Northcote City bench are up on their haunches. The Northcote City supporters are excited. The anticipation has built to the culmination of this, and the grand final has delivered in spades. They want the final whistle. Still might be another chance. Wow. Something here then for the 10-man Bentley Greens. Long goal kick from Webster. Ball in contention. Chance for the big fellow. Wilford keeps his head. Wilford does. Short pass for Matthews, and the ball is taken away. Wow. Hard stopper. They are thrilled about that. Wilford did well. Webster with the effort. Goalkeeper did better. And Northcote City are another couple of steps closer to a finish. It is going to be a free kick to Northcote City. That may well be game, set and match on this marvellous grand final, which has, again, I can't reiterate, Dougie, it really has had every element to a game.
Especially no love loss out there, Blakey. Their boys are still going. The game's finished. You can see the tackles are still flying in. They still want it. Bentley Greens are still fighting. Northcote is. I got referee. Has he got his mouth to us? No. Here we go. Northcote. Have they got another opportunity? Monty plays it across. Goal kick. They'll be getting the ball early. Webster looking for the ball off the ball boy. Grabs it. Put back in. Mate, this game, I tell you what, they get another opportunity, which is a great one by Wilford down there. Could have been another goal.
Yeah, it's got to be the referee. Lucien Lavadure has blown the final whistle! And a moment of delight for Northcote City Hercules. They have finally clinched their first Victorian championship against a team that you would have to say has had no luck this afternoon, the Bentley Greens. And the blue shirts congregate in the middle of the park to celebrate a remarkable victory. And what a great moment, which hopefully we can get on screen. The two coaches are embracing John Anastasiadis and Goran Lozanovsky. hugging former teammates in championship seasons in the NSL. But my oh my, I am absolutely, I don't know what these boys are feeling right now. Joy or absolute desolation. But I tell you what, I'm exhausted from what has been a remarkable struggle. Just to recap here at Amy Park on this quite remarkable afternoon. The Northcote players go over there supporting Northcote City. Look at them celebrating the championship, coming home for the very, very first time. A wonderful, wonderful moment. Just to recap, in a match of fluctuating fortunes that has engaged this terrific crowd at Amy Park this afternoon, and the commentary team of myself, Greg Blake, Doug Hodgson and young Griffin McMaster. It was Evan Kunavelis for Northcote City, putting them ahead in the second half of this game. An equaliser from Ryan DeVries, and then of course a goal from Luke Sherbon, making it 2-1 Bentley Greens. And just when you think that Milos Lewicz had failed on the biggest stage and the biggest occasion he's played in, up he bobs with an equaliser and a match winner to leave us with that final score in the Victorian Premier League 2013 Grand Final. Bentley Greens 2, Northcote City 3. Doug Hodgson and Griffo, where do we go with this? Where do we even start talking about it? Who was the Jimmy Rooney medalist? Let's talk.
Afternoon, mate. Hey, great game for spectators, great game for the crowd, great game for football, mate. It's a fantastic day here at Amy Park. Guys, it's end to end. We had a bit of red card, yellow cards, some good tackles, some fair, mate. By Jimmy Rooney, even the game went quite at times, the movements got a little bit static, but the captain of Northcote, Adam Chapati, remarkable, rock solid, didn't give him an inch all game. I thought he's manning done quite well, a good leader, got to take mine. It was him or the young mate out right here, Bill Avanas, but I actually need to say Adrian will take mine as a centre half.
Doug Hodgson there. Before we go to you, Griffo, you look at the Bentley Greens. The skipper, missed chance in the first minute. Sherbon's penalty miss on 19. The sheer willful stupidity of Luke Pilkington got himself sent off. A day of great opportunity and great promise and great wasted opportunity in the end for the Bentley Greens.
You pretty much summed it up, Blakey. They did have fantastic opportunities. Sherbon had a penalty. Went wide out on the right. Wide, as we mentioned before, why didn't he just go for a bit of finesse instead of power? Wayne Wallace, terrific opportunity in the first minute. Luke Pilkington showing a bit of bad discipline from him, down to 10 men. And that was probably the reason why they lost today. I know John Anastasiadis, he won't be very too happy about his character coming on and 1 minute later being sent back to the dressing room. But Bentley, they'll rue chances and discipline as the reasons why they lost today.
As we prepare for the presentations, the northern suburbs of Melbourne will go mad tonight as we go down to the presentation area.
In the Victorian Premier League, and a climax, great climax to the season. Please put your heads together for both the Bentley Greens and Northcote City. We'd like to welcome you on behalf of Football Federation Victoria and thank you for your attendance today and welcome to the medal presentation. We'd like to congratulate both teams on their first VPL Grand Final appearance with the final score 3-2, of course, in favour of Northcote City, and we congratulate Northcote City as the champions. A welcome to our dignitaries today. Nick Monteleone, President of the FFV, Mitchell Murphy, FFV CEO, and Elizabeth Miller, State Member for Bentley. Please come up to the stage. I'd also like to welcome up Jimmy Rooney, one of our greats, to present the Jimmy Rooney Medal. It is, of course, voted by the referees. And the winner of the Jimmy Rooney Medal is Milos Lucic. Milos, I'd now like to also thank our referees today, starting with the fourth official, Brenton Hayward, assistant referee one, Patrick Chaplin, Alessandro Abrizzani, and our referee today, Lucien Lavadieu. Please put your hands together for the refs. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that we welcome young players from both teams who will today present medallions to the runners-up and the winners. We begin with the runners-up from Bentley, and I'd like to welcome the young boys and girls from Bentley to help us with the presentation. I'd like to now welcome up the players from the Bentley Greens, starting with their goalkeeper, Stuart Webster. Number two, Dominic D'Angelo. Number 14, Aaron Wilford. Number 5, Jack Webster. Number 6, Thomas Matthews. Number 8, Wayne Wallace. Number 19, Liam McCormick. Number 13, Dane Milovanovic. Number 20, and one of the goal scorers for Bentley today, Luke Sherbin. Number 35, David Sturton. And Bentley's other goal scorer today, number 55, Ryan DeVries. I'd also like to welcome up the subs today, number 1, George Maliaris. Number 22, Nick Madafferi. Number 17, Jamie DeBrow. Number 24, Luke Pilkington. And number 77, Stephen Hatzikostas. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd also like to thank, and I'd like you to thank, the coaching staff from Bentley Green, starting with their physio, John Markov, team manager, Taz Panopoulos, assistant coach, John Gabrielson, and their coach, John Anastasiadis. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, a great season from Bentley. Please congratulate them on what has been a great campaign. Now time to acknowledge our winners for 2013. Starting with their goalkeeper, and what a save it was at the death, Chris Petropoulos. Number six, Bonel Obradovic. Number 12, Hayden D'Agostino. Marino Gasparis. The Jimmy Rooney medalist, Miloš Lujić. Michael Eager. James Kalafatidis. Alex Rojas. Score of the first goal today, Evan Kunavelis. And Christian Constantinidis. And the substitutes today, number one, Fraser Siddle. Michael Catalano. Harry Kinagopoulos. Dean Piemonte. Nick Tsoulis. And the captain, Adrian Chapetta.
Firstly, just want to say thank you to everyone that came today. You had a mad influence on the game. Beautiful atmosphere. It was perfect to play in front of. Secondly, our president, Peter Katsiris, do a top job, mate. Goran, Teddy, Sangos, and Mocha, behind the scenes, you do a top job as well. You've kept us throughout the year. And last but not least, the boys. What a season, lads. Fucking brilliant. Thank you. Also, lastly, Bentley, you've kept us on our toes all year, boys. Thank you for today. What a top game. Thank you very much.
I'd now like to welcome up the coaching staff as well. Their physio, Annabelle Redford. Their team manager, Nick Tsamis. The assistant coach, Ted Lozanowski. And the coach, Goran Lozanowski.
Just before I let everyone go home,
Firstly, commiserations to Bentley Greens on the fantastic season they had this year. Obviously, on grand final day, there's only one winner. But, fantastic season. Johnny, you guys were awesome all year and probably a little bit unfortunate today, but well done, even to the players and the guys at the club as well. Fantastic. Secondly, I want to say Northcote City, look at this crowd. It's fantastic. I can't believe it. Awesome. Awesome. I'd like to thank, obviously, our supporters, and make sure you're back at the clubhouse today. My players, mate, fantastic effort today. We probably weren't at our best today, but we had shown a lot of heart. We dug deep, and we got to victory. Fantastic. Obviously, my coaching staff, fantastic. Everyone that behind the scenes in Northcote City, awesome. Fantastic year. Thank you very much.
I'd now like to invite the president of the FFE, Nick Montaglione, to present the trophy to the champions, Northcote City.
So, ladies and gentlemen,
thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses.